Thanks for coming up.
My shot's not good, Colonel.
Tell me when. I think we are live on Facebook. Now we're going to be live on TV. It's a live morning, so we're all alive. Okay?
So far.
So far, so good. It's raining, but no lightning strikes. So anyway, good morning, everybody. Jim Weller here. I am back from vacation. I had a great time. I missed being with you. I want to say thank you to Brooks Ritter, Colin Walls, Colin II, Brandon Ritter, who is not in the room at the moment, but everybody did a good job, and I really felt that you guys did fantastic. So it was almost like I wasn't here.
Well, thank
you.
So,
yep. So did you have fun?
Almost like you weren't here.
Yeah. Did you have any fun with it?
We did have fun with it, yeah.
Good.
Yep. Brandon is out heating his eyes up right now. His eyes are cold.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He's got the eye heater.
Eye heater, yep. That's the newest thing we're selling. Okay, just don't stare at it long. All right. He, in the summertime, he uses a magnifying glass to warm up his eyes. But in the winter, he uses an eye heater. So, all right. So, first of all, good morning. Got a really neat new idea while I was on this trip. But first, let's do a commercial for Wall Service Center. Good morning, Colin.
Good morning.
How is Wall Service Center?
Wall Service Center is great.
Good. I took a trip. And before that, I had some things done to my vehicle, and it was just, I have to be honest with you, it was just comforting, you know, just knowing everything had been looked over, everything was in good order,
right.
And I like that. So so thank you for that. I forgot what all we did. I know it was an oil change to rotate the tires.
Right.
And after rotating the tires, it actually rode a little smoother. So I guess maybe the front tires were just a little choppy, and we moved them to the back. And I know you're not in the tire business, but, you know, it was something that you did during the oil change, and so thank you for that.
Well,
so,
you're welcome. Well, thank you for the business. And
yep.
We did put fall air in the tires also.
Oh, now that's what it was then. Okay. Autumn air. Remember that. Okay. All right. So Wall Service Center going to be open today at 8 o'clock. Is that correct?
8 o'clock. Jesse is going to be opening up today. So,
there we go.
Yeah, Tracy has the day off, and I'll be in there a little bit later. So,
all right. Well, Tracy, enjoy the day off. I'm sure she's tuned in right now.
I'm sure she
making
is.
Sure
she's...
that we don't forget she has the day off.
Right.
So, so it's Jesse, you say?
Jesse will be opening today.
So I would like everybody to write down this number. It's 422. Oh, you asked for the area code. It's 302-422-8110, and about 8:05, maybe even 8 o'clock, right on the nose. Mm-hmm. Call Jesse and say good morning. Say good morning to him, in other words, and schedule some work while you're at it. And if you don't need anything done, schedule it for your neighbor and pay for their oil change or something like that.
Idea.
Yeah, so just pay it forward if you would.
Engine replacement,
right. Muffler bearings, serpentine belts, and all that stuff. So anyway, Wall Service Center, downtown Milford. Anything new you want to mention or any real current experience where you say, yeah, we had a guy come all the way from the other side of Greenwood. And where do your customers come from?
Well, they come from all over. You know, we've had people come from Ocean City, the Millville area, even Delmar, and you know, a lot from Greenwood, Bridgeville area, and of course Milford and Harrington and the immediately surrounding communities. Lots from Milford.
Right, and you have a lot of people drop their stuff off, go to work, pick it back up. Real nice hours. What is it, 7:30? They could get there as early as 7:30, Monday
right.
through Friday,
mm-hmm.
till 5:30, and then Saturday, 8 to noon.
Right, and that's the hours we're actually there. We also have a key drop, so you can drop your keys at any time.
I've experienced that, yep.
Right, so just park your car out there and drop your key through the door there. There's a mail slot. You can drop it right in there, and we'll get you taken care of.
Okay. Well, very good. So downtown Milford, 220 Northeast Front Street,
right.
All types of automotive repairs, whatever you may need, locally owned, locally operated. Colin Walls is the third generation to run the business. His grandfather started it in 1958. So they've been serving people of the community for 58 years. So anyway, if you need anything done to your automobile, whether it's brakes or a muffler or a complete exhaust system or just a tune-up or new plugs and wires or an air filter or anything, brakes, rotors, and so on and so forth. They can help you out if you just want to make sure your antifreeze is at the right level. You know, it's the time of year. Things are cooling down. Air pressure, make sure you got the right air pressure in your tires. Check your wipers. Any automotive repairs, right down to truly replacing an engine or a transmission, they do that too. So they don't do body work, and they don't sell tires, but pretty much other than that, they can take good care of you, and they stand behind what they do. Their prices are fair. They're honest. They'll give you an idea of what you're looking at before they get in the middle of it. No big surprises. prices. And like I say, can we talk about that little what's it called? Where if you have you need to have your car jumped or
the roadside assistance.
Roadside assistance. Yep, I forgot about that.
Absolutely free with every service from an oil change on up.
I thought about it when I was on my trip. In other words, I just got an oil change done plus some other stuff.
Right.
But I remembered you had said this roadside assistance or whatever it's called, that program comes for free with whatever service work you get done.
Right. It does.
Okay, so and what you basically do is you dial an 800 number. You're not going to get Colin, of course, but you're going to call a company that has relationships with repair facilities or towing companies all over the United States. And it's just kind of comforting, you know, if you're on a trip and you say, well, who would I call? Well, I've already got this number, and they pay for so many miles of a tow or something. I don't know if it's a jump start or change your spare or what. There's a mess of stuff.
Exactly. So if you have a flat tire, they'll put your spare on. If you need a towing service, they'll have you towed. If you run out of gas, you need a jump start.
Okay.
Those types of things. Lock your keys in your car.
Right. So all of those things. And, you know, if you're home and it happens, you kind of know who you could call on. But if you're in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, you don't know who to call on. You call this 800 number. They've already got it established. And it doesn't cost me anything. So anyway, we're getting ready to come live on the radio. But that's Wall Service Center, 422-8110. Give them a call. And good morning, good morning, good morning to everybody out there. Jim Weller back from vacation, joining you live right here on Delaware 105.9, My Cozy TV, and we're also streaming at Weller Does Delmarva, plus we're on Facebook Live. So we're kind of like air. We're everywhere, okay? And some days fog is everywhere and confusion is everywhere, so we're also everywhere. So good morning. I had a real good vacation, real, real good vacation. I was like at the dunes in Myrtle Beach. That's the name of the place, and my daughter Jenny coordinates it all, and Jason's mom and dad went. Jenny and Jason and the kids went, and then myself and Denise went. For some strange reason, the drive down was better than I remember. It was only like maybe 10 hours versus last year it seemed like 12. But we had a real good time, went out on the beach. But the place we stayed also has two buildings with like indoor water parks, indoor pools. So you can go in there up till 11 o'clock at night, or you can go out during the day on the beach. So had a lot of fun. Saw a lot of storm damage down there. A lot of areas flooded, and tremendous amount of trees just snapped off, blown over, or snapped right off. Some of them were snapped off 20 feet tall up in the air, and it was just amazing. And just stuff everywhere, debris everywhere. They're just basically, you know, getting everything off the sidewalks and out of the road, and then it looks like they'll clean it up at a later date. So anyway, but a lot of roof damage. And then there was one little area I stumbled across where I was watching TV last week before I went, and there was houses on fire. They were like condos. And they were saying that the fire company doesn't get involved if the wind is over 40 miles an hour. And I guess from a safety point of view, that probably makes good sense. You know, the people are out of the building. There's not much you can do. But I stumbled across them, and I was like, this is awful. It was one building after another that it burnt, some across the street. And there were people, like, going in with plastic tubs, just getting their stuff and coming back out. So anyway, you want to cherish every moment with everything you got, because life can change at the blink of an eye. So I'm back. I got a really neat idea on this vacation, okay? And I have come up with this idea to give away a box full of merchandise, okay? And there's like 70-some things, 77 individual things in this box. And you have to call me at 337-7300, 337-7300, and say, Jim, that adds up to $342. You need to tell me the dollar amount that those 77 items add up to, and if you are the closest to that, you win it. Absolutely free, no purchase necessary. So, Brooks, I need to ask you a question. If we stop taking callers at 8:45, will we have time to figure out if anybody guessed it?
Sure.
Can we in 15 minutes figure that out, you think?
I would think so.
Okay, so we're going to announce the winner by the end of the show.
Okay.
Okay. So you've got to 8:45 this morning to call 337-7300 and guess how much all this stuff adds up to. Okay.
Do you have a question for you?
No, no questions. Colin, can you stick it up here?
I wish you could just dump it right out.
Oh,
If you can, yeah. So I want everybody to see what we're talking about. And I guess you can leave it out on the table till Barry gets here, and then we got to pick it all back up. But it's like, here's an umbrella carrier. You put your umbrella in it. Here's a little, I don't know if it's called die-cast or... What's your question, Brooks? I know you got one.
Is this, like, the Price is Right, the closest without going over, or just the closest?
No, they period? Can't go over.
Yeah, so
wait a minute. How you want to do it? You're in charge here.
No, I'm not.
How do you want to do this contest, Brooks?
I would say the closest without going over.
Oh, man. Are you sure?
Yeah, let's make it a little more complicated.
All right. Look at this item. Tell me, how many places that sell utility trailers stock these?
None.
Okay.
Well, I take that back. One. Us.
One. Us. Okay. Well, anyway, you will not find these just everywhere, okay? They're Tomcat rat traps, all right? And you get two of them. So where I got this idea was a place called the Gay Dolphin. Anybody been there?
Nope.
It's a place that's been at Myrtle Beach so long, my wife remembers going there with her grandparents. Here is their bag. But we go in there, and they're selling an item. And my grandkids all wanted one. I was like, you're kidding me. You don't even know what it is. So they said, I want one. I want one. So here's what they got. It was $1.98. So here's where I got this idea. They bought this for $1.98, and all of them wanted one, not having any idea what's in it. So you could tell they're my grandchildren. Anyway, not having any idea what's in it, but recognizing for $1.98, it might be an interesting little adventure. So I thought, well, gee whiz, I'm going to box up a box load of stuff and just sell the box with nobody knowing what's in it. But today I thought I would give the box away for starters, okay? So again, don't forget the number, 337-7300. For those watching on wherever you're watching, look at all the stuff. You're talking about this little die-cast truck. You're talking about a rat trap. You're talking about this little case. This is a really nice case. It zippers shut, and you could put notes in it. What would you call this, a pad folio or something like that?
Well, yeah, that works.
That works. See it here? It's real nice. Where's the zipper? It opens up. This is probably about a $20 item. See it there? So anyway, kind of a handy little thing to have. We got the leather wine bottle carrier. We got a Zag cleaning kit. Whole bunches of tissues. What's these things called? Air fresheners. Like 30 ink pens. And a bunch of socks. And there's, what's this? Like a mug with a T-shirt in it. NASCAR racing T-shirt in a mug or something like that, right?
Yep.
So all we're asking you, it's real simple. How much does all that add up to in money? And you're saying you can't go over.
That's correct.
But you got to be the closest to it, and whoever guesses that number, they win it.
Pretty simple.
Let me think. Is there any other rules to this contest?
One guess.
Next week, we're going to be selling them, okay? This $1.98 thing, man, I thought that was ingenious. Now, I have to be honest. I did ask if they would sell me 500 of these for $1 a piece. They said, we won't even sell you 500 of them for $1.98. They only had a few of them. So it was kind of, because it's a lot of neat little stuff in there. Man, it made our kids real happy. So I like that. All right. Can I move on?
Sure.
All right. Are you sure?
Yes.
We got Barry from Dry Zone on the way.
He'll be coming in.
Does anybody know if he's woke up? Does mom wake him up? Barry, somehow let us know you're awake. No, he'll be here. I'm just messing with him. He's probably not even listening. So Wilson's Auction having a big sale today. Let me look that up while Brooks is talking to everybody.
You caught me off guard. I moved away from my microphone. Then you're like, I moved away from my microphone. Then you said, why, Brooks is talking.
Yeah, well, you keep talking while I look up Wilson's Auction. And while you're listening, everybody, you can look them up, too. It's Wilson's Auction because they've got two property auctions coming up, not today, but next Saturday. I was looking at a couple houses that they're going to be selling. I think one's in Laurel and one's in Dover. Now, of course, every Saturday, starting with this Saturday, at about 10 o'clock this morning, Wilson's in Lincoln has a building full of stuff, inside, outside, and all kinds of things for sale, household items and furniture and antiques and glassware and tools and exercise equipment and a little bit of everything. But then on Tuesday night, so that's today. So today going into the day and the evening at Wilson's Auction in Lincoln, all kinds of stuff. Great day for an auction, so plan on checking them out. Then Tuesday nights, they have an auto auction every Tuesday night at 6 o'clock. So whether you want to buy a car, sell a car, they can help you out there. But then you go to their website, and it says upcoming auctions. What's today's date, Brooks?
Today's the 22nd.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway, today at 10 o'clock, they're having an auction. The 25th is Tuesday night. But then it says the 29th, which is next Saturday. So they have the auction again there at Lincoln. But then they've got these real estate. And I'm always interested in it because I have a lot of rentals. And I've bought many of them from Wilson's Auction at auction. And I got very good deals and was very pleased at buying property that way. So the 29th, which is next Saturday at 11 o'clock, they have a piece of property, a house in Laurel, okay, on Seaford Road in Laurel, okay? Then at 2:30 next Saturday, they have another house in Magnolia. So anyway, go to their auction, their website, which is wilsonsauction.com, and check out all the different things they have going on because it's a busy, busy auction company, and they'll take good care of you. But if you got something you want to sell, you give them a call, you want to buy something, just get there. Wilsonsauction.com. They do on sale sites at your place, or they have the auction every Saturday and Tuesday night there in Lincoln. What is the phone number, Jim? 422-3454. 422-3454. Wilsonsauction.com. Good people. They'll take good care of you, and I highly recommend them. All right, now, are we talking to Brandon next, or am I just going to move right along?
You can talk to Brandon.
I can talk to Brandon. Brandon, come sit amongst my collection.
Barry did say he is awake.
Barry's awake.
Barry's awake.
All right, everybody, quit worrying. Barry's awake. All right, you're going to need a microphone somehow. He's got the yellow one, the yellow cordless. Don't forget that phone number. Do you know the number for to guess the dollar amount of all the items?
Is it 337?
Oh, you have to get 70? Area code. People need the area code.
302.
Okay.
337.
Yep.
7300.
He got it. 337-7300.
We've had callers.
Well, here's the deal. You can't do this. Oh. All right. You can't do this. But anyway.
I need a calculator out.
I know.
What's up?
But anyway, if somebody guesses how much all this sells for at Weller's in Bridgeville, and they guess the closest, but they can't go over, Brooks said. So it's got to be that amount or under. Okay. They win it all. No questions asked. How's
neat
that?
Neat little collection here.
That's a neat little collection, isn't it?
It is. Somebody's going to be happy.
There's a lot of stuff there, isn't there?
There is.
Oh, I forgot the license plate. What's it say? If you can't run with the big dogs, stay off the porch. All right. Anyway,
I hang out on the porch a lot.
Yep. Anyway. All right, Brandon, what's up in your world?
Oh, there's a lot going on in my world.
All right. I've been gone for a week. What have you accomplished?
Absolutely nothing.
Great.
At least he's telling the truth.
Nothing's different. Normally, everything stayed the same. All right, everything was normal. Are we going outside? No, we're not going outside because it's raining now.
Yeah, it's a little wet out there.
But we have some neat trailers outside, so let's pretend we're outside describing these trailers. Or,
well, and
something else.
I did do a little spoiler alert video.
Oh,
so,
did you really?
If you want to see
on your own product,
I did.
Dang, go on.
And on the trailers that we'll be discussing today. So if they want to go on there and just kind of get a brief glimpse of them, they can.
So that's
do
the
that.
Show before the show.
The show before the show.
All right,
yes.
I got to get a show before that show. All right. So anyway,
we have a selection of trailers out there. One
over the enclosed since it's a rainy day.
Yeah. One particular line that we just picked up is the Hallmark Thrifty Hauler.
Hallmark has been around a long time, have they not?
They have. They have. They are a very, very well-named brand, good quality brand trailer.
Yep. Nationwide warranty.
They do have a nationwide warranty, and they just came out with a line called the Thrifty Hauler.
Okay.
And it's really, I like to call it a hybrid trailer.
Okay.
It's kind of a mixture of good quality trailer, but affordable prices.
Okay.
They've come out with a really nice trailer.
Right, because this would have the same warranty as all their trailers.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. And of course,
hybrid,
Hallmark.
Does that mean it's an electric trailer?
No.
Okay.
Hybrid usually means a mixture.
Okay.
Mixture. Okay. Like your hybrid cars are sometimes
like
gas
and electric.
Like I have
a hybrid bicycle.
Yes, yours is pedal powered and motor powered.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
So that's a hybrid bicycle.
All right.
So anyways, real nice brand of trailer at an affordable price. You get the Hallmark warranty. They have radial tires. They have this.
They have radial tires?
Radial tires.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Real.
So I'm going to call these a first-time buyer trailer.
Yeah. Yeah.
In other words, so somebody, you know, entry-level trailer, in other words. So it's because what you're running into, there's a lot of people building trailers out there, and there's no industry standard.
Right.
So you go from one trailer dealer to another trailer dealer, and you just hope and pray they told you enough stuff about a trailer to make sure you – and then it gets even worse. You get on the internet.
Exactly.
You know. But
exactly. And this trailer's perfect for – I want the cheapest thing you have, but I want the nicest thing you have.
Right.
It's a good mixture of
Michelin tires, but the cheapest thing you
have. But the cheapest thing you got, yeah.
Right. But so you're saying it's a name brand trailer with a nationwide warranty, you know, built to their specs and their standards.
Exactly.
What is it? 7 foot wide, 14 foot long?
7 foot wide, 14 foot long.
Is it about 6 foot inside?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
V-nose front end, aerodynamic.
Yep.
Stone guard.
Stone guard. It has a ramp gate on the back.
All right.
Flush lock side door.
So that let's explain what a flush lock side door. It has like a little paddle latch. It just has a deadbolt on it. It's a little more secure.
Yep.
You can lock or unlock it from the inside or open or unopen it from the inside.
Correct.
So, all right. And so it's got a side door and a ramp door.
Mm-hmm.
It's got drop axles, so it's a little lower to the ground.
Right.
Easier to load. Pulls a little better.
Right.
Okay. And then what else? Electric brakes on both axles.
Brakes on both axles, and they have a flush-mounted D-rings on the inside.
I got something else it's got. I hope it does. No, I think I remembered something. Rear stabilizer jacks.
Yes.
Now, that is nice. Now,
see, I was going to hide that from the customer and kind of surprise them.
Surprise. It's springing on them then. Underneath the rear of the trailer, folks, it has these jacks. They're like spring-loaded. You pull them to the left or the right, and then they pop down. And it's so let's say you had it unhooked from a vehicle. Let's say you were a contractor or you had some motorcycles or four-wheelers, and you wanted to load or walk up and down the back of the trailer, but it's not hooked to a vehicle. You put these down, and it makes it so it won't tilt up on you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got it. So what would you expect to pay for that?
Well, they are very affordable.
$5,000, $4,800, something like that?
Lower.
Lower?
Yeah.
For real?
For real.
What year are these? 15, 16?
These are brand spanking new trailers.
Brand new. Just got here. All right. So we got 7 foot wide, 14 foot long, ramp door, side door. And it's not going to be $4,800,
$4,900? No.
Okay.
Actually going to be $4,299.
Man, I see used trailers, $3,500, $3,800.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so $42.99, name brand,
name
quality
brand.
Trailer. I'm going to presume we don't have a lot because I think these are just getting started.
Right.
Okay. All right. And what color is it?
We have it in white.
Okay. Does it have a one-piece roof?
Getting to ask if we talked about the roof yet. It has a one-piece aluminum roof.
Really?
Yeah.
A one-piece roof.
It is. Wow. It is great bang for your buck.
It sounds like it.
Yeah.
It sounds like it. No real risk there because you don't have to buy a no-name trailer to get that kind of a price. You can buy a name brand trailer and get the price.
Absolutely.
Very good. I'm pleased we're selling Hallmark.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We've sold quite a few. They're very pleased with us.
Yes.
All right. So to call you, what do they do?
They give us a call. You can reach us through the store, which is 302-337-8228.
Can they call right now?
They can call right now, but I don't think anybody's going to be there to pick up the phone yet.
All right.
But
you want to give yourself? Okay, go ahead.
And you can also reach me on my cell phone number, which is 302-542-7794. They can call that right now.
Right now. What
right
is
now.
That again?
302-542-7794.
All right, very good. So call Brandon now, even if you have any questions or if you want to buy two of those. Are we allowing people to buy two?
They can buy two, three, or four if they want.
Buy two, three, or four. Okay. What? Brooks, are you all right? That was pretty quick thinking there, wasn't it? Two, three, or four. All right.
Whatever
so
anyway, they want.
What's it, 542-7794. Call him right now just so he knows that his advertising dollars were spent on a live audience, okay? We make Brandon pay for his own ads.
I want to make sure everybody's awake.
All right. Anything else? You coming back later?
I'll be back later.
I want to talk about that aluminum landscape trailer.
Okay, we'll do that.
All right. Anyway, we got Barry on his way from Dry Zone. We have had phone calls for the box. So basically, the deal is you're watching. You see all this stuff here on the table. All you got to do is guess how much these 77 items would sell for in the store if you guess closest to the dollar amount, and but don't go over, then you win it because there's only going to be one winner, okay? Now, we do need to make sure everybody knows only one guess per person, okay? So, you know, in other words, just don't keep guessing different numbers. I don't even know if anybody's doing that. I'm just saying, but it's one guess per person. All right, but we have had the phone calls today. We got brand new calendars. I need to say that real quick because people do not want our used calendars. So we got some brand new 2017 calendars ready to go, or they'll at least be ready by Monday.
They'll
in other words,
today.
People can pick up today.
Yeah, why not?
I don't know. You got to get them out of the box and everything else. So in other words,
I don't think that's going to take a couple of hours to
All
do.
Right.
It might take, you know, maybe 30 seconds.
Okay. I'm giving you plenty of time here.
I just hope they've got them counted so they make sure they got what they ordered.
Oh, that's a good thing. Oh, there you go. Well, we will have them out on display by Monday for sure. Brooks is saying today. So I guess ask for Brooks if you want a new calendar. Can I do an ad for no-nonsense office machines?
I think that makes sense.
Okay. Getting a lot of people guessing on this, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
All right. So anyway, no-nonsense office machines. I remember I went down there a couple weeks ago. And I want to encourage you, if you're just listening and you need anything in the electronic world, new or used, go ahead and stop down there. No-nonsense office machines is in Georgetown. They're like 2 miles east of the Circle, right there next to Sports at the Beach Complex. And they have a little bit of everything. I mean, I'm talking a little bit of everything. Everything from laptops to tablets, computers, fax machines, gaming systems, printers, whatever you may need, Rick Fowler and his team can fix you up. They have new stuff. They have used stuff. They have everything in between. They stand behind what they sell. And they're good people to deal with. Now, you also already may own something yourself, and you just want to get it fixed or serviced or something like that. They also can help you with that. So anyway, it's no-nonsense office machines. They're, like I say, on Route 9, 2 miles east of the Circle, and they'll take good care of you. I have had stuff worked on. I have bought stuff there. I think Colin Walls just recently bought some laptops there, and we went down, and Rick's got a nice showroom full of all kinds of merchandise. And, of course, whether you need something worked on, whether you need some information, he is just a good, friendly, honest man. So his phone number is 856-7381, 856-7381. If you want to get anything from laptops, tablets, computers, fax machines, gaming systems, printers, one-stop shopping for all your electronic needs. So anyway, give him a call, 856-7381. All right, next is going to be, we're going to talk about another auction. I mentioned Wilson's auction today, but there's a whole nother auction going on. Very exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Are you excited, Brooks?
Yeah, I think you should bid on it, and then just you can put it on my vehicle.
I actually intend to buy it.
There you go. And then we can put it on my vehicle.
What do you got that will go on the beach?
If I drive fast enough, my van will go on the beach.
Until it gets buried in the sand.
Exactly. But
folks,
then it'll look good with a number one tag on the front of it.
Would you honestly ride around with that on the front of that van?
Absolutely.
Could I get you to buy a nicer vehicle if I bought the tag?
I might think about it.
Okay. Right. Well, anyway, yes. I'm looking at it more from an investment point of view.
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to look at it from the angle of if you bought this tag and owned it for a few years, you might be able to resell it and make a dollar.
It's not something
that's going to become less in demand. It will become more in demand.
It is the
only
one. Because
once it's sold, everybody's going to want it.
Yeah.
Because then everybody's going to say, dang, I should have bought that thing. All right. So anyway, we're going to talk with Ray about that. All right.
I'm excited.
Okay.
I'm on the edge of my seat.
Are you telling me if I buy this tag, you would ride around with it on the front of your vehicle?
Absolutely.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Okay. We might let you. All right. So are we getting ready to take a break from the radio or not just yet?
We're just about there.
All right. So we're going to take a break from the radio. We're going to be with you on TV. We got some stuff we want to talk about. I don't even know what it is, but we're going to be back in just a few minutes. Go over to Facebook Live, and check us out there, too, or My Cozi TV. All right, everybody. Now, for my viewing audience, Colin, did you want to talk about something?
Sure.
Let's talk about, did you just do the Milford Parade?
Yes, we did.
Okay, and you were in it. Were you the guy with that big baton, or what's it called?
Yes, that was absolutely not me.
What is that called?
Is that the Grand Marshal?
Grand Marshal?
Yeah.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know.
All right. So people, if somebody doesn't have any idea what we're talking about, Milford Community Parade, can they watch it right now somewhere?
No.
Okay. So they can't. It was
right.
Like a
thanks for bringing
gun.
That up.
Okay. I didn't know, in other words. I'm trying to make sure people understand the value of watching things while they're happening. All right. So was it on TV?
Yes, it was on TV. It was right here on my TV.
I talked to somebody that watched it, and they were from, like, Maryland.
Really? Yeah.
Yeah. They were watching it in Maryland. Okay.
Yep.
So anyway, it was on My Cozi TV.
It was, yeah. Right. Yeah, but this Saturday coming up,
How about next Saturday? That sounds better.
Big. Not today, but next week, yeah.
The 29th, folks.
The 29th.
For those using the MICA calendar.
Yeah, big parade coming up. Sea Witch Parade. We're actually going to broadcast your show live from
Rehoboth Avenue. Where are we going to be? Right in front of the library?
We're going to be right in front of the library, yeah.
Okay, so right people can come join us in person next Saturday.
That's right, yeah.
Okay.
Live audience.
We're going to need those things from Mid-South Audio. What are they called?
Crowd control barriers.
Right. Yeah.
Right. Armed guards.
Armed guards, yeah. We want them to be armed. Okay, let's get serious now.
Yeah,
in other
serious.
Words, so you did the Milford Parade. Now you're going to do the Sea Witch Parade.
Sea Witch Parade.
So that's going to be on my Cozi TV.
No, it's not. That is going to be on NBC, WRDE's NBC station. So it's the sister station to my Cozi, but it's actually the NBC station.
How come it's not the brother station?
I don't know.
Okay. So anyway, I just wanted to check with you. So it's called the sister station.
That's what it's called.
What time's it going on?
I'm not sure. I don't know. I think it may be 10:30 or 11.
Can I sell
like
any ads
check
during
your
this?
Local listings?
All right. Can anybody buy an ad during this?
Yeah, you would probably need to call check with the TV station WRDE, right. Bob Backman.
Bob Backman.
Their sales manager.
Sales department.
Yes, the sales department.
All right. I'm asking you all kinds of crazy questions today.
Right. I'm just producing it. I'm not selling ads in that
okay,
one.
So Catch It Live is the one that's producing it.
Exactly, yes.
All right, for WRDE.
Right.
But we really appreciate WRDE being willing to broadcast these local events in their entirety.
Oh, right, yeah, and that's kind of Bob Backman's stated
correct
mission is to
right
to really put out, you know, all these good local events that have been sorely missed on television.
Yeah, right, because nobody does live TV anymore except them.
Right.
All right, what do you want to talk about during this little segment?
It doesn't matter, that's fine.
Okay, well, anyway, are you going to the tag auction with me today?
I don't think I'm going to be able to make it.
Do you have any blank checks you'd like to send with me?
Yes.
Yep. Okay, good.
Yep. I'll go get them out of your desk drawer here in a couple minutes.
It's going to be a big turnout. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'll tell you something else that's interesting about the tag thing is there's all these trailers there with big barbecue things set up inside of them.
Right.
So, in other words, it's quite a trailer market.
I think there's, I don't know, I think there's like 75 or 80 different competitors there.
Really?
Yeah.
For real?
For real.
Okay. So, anyway, now what are we doing?
We're getting ready to come back on the air.
On the radio. We're already on the air.
Yeah, we're already on the air.
Yes.
Okay.
On the radio.
He does it. He goes like this, then he pulls on his air.
Right.
I don't know what he's saying to me. Okay. What are you saying, Brooks?
We're on the air.
All right. Is this new?
That's a new prop.
It's a new prop for Halloween.
There's a spider coming down.
He just wanted his 2 seconds of fame.
Okay. Well, he can have it. All right. I don't know if
squish him.
Okay. Now, what else have we got?
We have got a jam-packed show.
No doubt about it. So let me do an ad for First Class Heating and Air.
Mm-hmm.
And then let me get Ray Bivens on here. And we're going to talk about these tags. You bring the other ones with you, Ray? Just one? Just one. Okay. Well, anyway. Oh, really? That's true, right. After that, it's going to be on Brooks's van. All right. Well, Ray, why don't you come on over, and we'll go ahead and hit this now, just to be on the safe side. I don't want to go from heating and air conditioning repairs all the way to the tag. So we'll leave you in suspense about First Class Heating and Air, but we are going to talk about the tag. A lot of hype about this tag. In other words, everybody seems to be excited. You don't have to buy it and then go have it made into a black and white when you've already done that. This is a black and white from the get-go.
Absolutely.
Okay, and you are going to be auctioning that off today. I mean, is there any reserve, or is it going to be an absolute auction?
It's going to be sold today. So today, there's a lot of firsts today. So
a lot of firsts.
Only number one tag to be sold. We've been talking about this, it seems like, for 2 years.
Yeah,
today is the day.
So
we have the thing I don't think a lot of people are talking about. There's lots of folks out there that have four-digit black and white tags for the back of their vehicle.
Okay.
Today is the first day that you can buy a four-digit tag. So we're doing some choice auctions of 1,001 through 5,000 and 5,001 through 999.
Of four-number tags.
Yep. So you could match what's on the back with what's on the front.
Okay.
It's gonna take us a little while. It'll take us about a month to deliver that because we're not printing all 10,000 of those plates. But
you're not?
Yeah. But
you're
on demand.
With a print and press.
That'd be
them right there at the BBQ. So you're saying, give me an example. So starting with tag number 1,001.
Well, I was driving down here today from through Felton, and I tag 3380 passed me.
Okay.
And I thought, well, that's a pretty good number. And right. It was on a nice pickup truck. And I was like, I hope he knows today's the day that he can show up at the inlet. And at 2:30, he can buy that choice auction. Okay. And he can be one of the first.
Wow.
And then one of the other things we have going that it came kind of late in the game.
How many of them?
We're doing a choice of 501 to 999. A choice of 1,001 to 5,000, and then a choice of
But only one, meaning if you wanted, what was that number, 36-something?
3380, you would be buying that choice of 1,001 to 5,000.
But whoever wins that bid is the only person today that can buy, end up with a four-number tag.
Yep, so our plan is probably about 13 tags will be sold today altogether.
Wow.
Some great numbers, too. You know, everyone's talking
number
about...
Number five,
so they're...
This is the Troop 5 area. Somebody should buy it over here, okay?
And, you know, I don't think people realize 2's gone, 3's gone, 4's gone, 8's gone, 9's gone. So if you're thinking about
getting a single... Did you sell
10? 10 has not been sold yet. No.
But 11 is going to be sold today.
And 11's going to be sold today. So
okay.
If you were
so whoever buys 1 should also buy 11.
If you can't get 1, get 11 or, you know, what? Get both. You know,
no, I would get both. Okay. Now, there is a detail. They have to be a Delaware resident to buy tag number 1 through 200.
They do. That was per law.
Just 1 through 200.
Just
though.
1 through 200.
Okay. All right. Now, and they're going to be sold no matter what they bring. So if this tag only brings $10,000, you're selling it.
That's true.
But if it brings $110,000, you're still willing to sell it.
We're willing to sell it for that as well.
Now, where's the money go?
So it all stays with Delaware State Parks, and this has been just an amazing story so far. So
John Adkins is the one who, you know, kind of brain or what's it called? This was his idea.
It was his brainchild. Yep.
Yeah.
He told me before this bill was moving that this was a $1 million idea.
He's right on it.
Well, and I at the time I didn't see that. I was like, man, this is going to be a lot of work, and I don't think it's going to be a $1 million idea. But
what county are you from?
I'm from Kent.
Okay.
So
John's from Sussex.
Yeah, he was on it. So
okay.
We've sold about 90 tags, and we've made over $300,000.
Were you surprised at that?
I was. Some of the other numbers is what surprised me. You know?
Okay.
And I've had experts in tags tell me that these choice tags are going to sell sometimes higher than some of the individual numbers we're going to sell today.
I agree.
Which that kind of surprised me. So that's the order of auction. And,
okay.
And the one that we haven't been able to really advertise is we had a donation since all the proceeds go to Delaware State Parks. But Motor Vehicles has donated the true black and white tag for the back of your vehicle, tag number 6209. And we're going to pair that with the surf tag 6209.
Okay.
So if you're new to all this and you want to go one-stop shopping, you can leave today with black and white tag for the back of your vehicle and the surf tag for the front of your vehicle.
Wow. Can't leave with them, but you could be the winner of them.
You'll be the winner. Yeah.
Be the winner of them.
Yeah. Okay. You'll get an IOU from me.
They won't let me have them because they want to make sure my check clears the bank. All right, you do take checks.
We do take checks. We take credit cards. And, of course, cash still works.
Is there an extra fee for the credit card?
There's a small transaction
okay.
fee. I think
just
it's
checking.
About 3%.
That'd be fine. All right. What else? You're taking cash. You're taking checks. You're taking credit cards. It starts today, October 22nd, at 2:30. Get there probably 1:30, 2 o'clock.
Yeah, you got to register in advance. You need to put a $200 deposit down.
Okay.
Just to make sure, you know.
And you have to have a bidder's number.
You'll get a bidder's number.
Okay.
We've got a much bigger tent. If you were there last year, we're
yeah.
expecting a bigger crowd.
Okay.
So there's plenty of room underneath the tent. And there's some great numbers today. So it's part of BBQ by the Sea, major special event. We can talk about that a little later. But we're talking tag 200. Tag 400, tag 500, some more choice. So anything between 31 and 99, if you have a favorite number there. And you know it's football season. A lot of people are somewhat attached to their old football numbers. There's a lot of football numbers between 31 and 99.
Boy, there is. This is a great idea. Great idea. So it's today. And where is it?
So as you come over the Indian River Bridge heading south,
okay.
you look right on the south campground, and
okay.
you'll see it is just invaded with barbecuers. So
okay.
we have a...
So about what point do you start smelling the barbecue?
Once you're out of your car, you start
okay.
smelling the barbecue.
Right.
And that salt air mixed with the barbecue...
Makes it tasty.
...is amazing. And the rigs, I think we have folks from 12 different states in this barbecue competition. I would encourage people... you know, everyone comes to the special event part, but not very many people walk through and talk to the barbecuers and ask them what they're doing. And at certain points throughout the day, they're a little stressed because they got to get the brisket just perfect or the ribs or those type of things. But they love to talk to folks. I mean, they've invested a lot of money.
You know, just their trailers.
A lot of really nice trailers down there.
A lot of nice trailers.
I'm sure there's some people looking to upgrade as well.
Yep, very proud of them. In other words, they could tell you all the details about them. Anyway, this is a big event. This is all a fundraiser that helps make money for the Delaware Seashore State Parks. And
I got one more trick up my sleeve.
Okay.
So the folks from Pumpkin Chunkin' reached out to us. And this year is the first year that they've
it's
ever
be back.
It's this back, is, and it's they've back. Printed numbered tickets. So they have 1 through 50,000, and whatever tag you buy today, they're going to give you the matching Pumpkin Chunkin' ticket. So whoever buys tag number one is going to leave with Pumpkin Chunkin' ticket number one for the return of 2016 Pumpkin Chunkin'.
That's pretty cool. Now, I look at these strictly as a business opportunity myself, in other words. So, you know, if a person is a business person and says, you know, look, I'm going to buy this tag and I'm just going to relax and sit on it a little bit, you know, or just keep buying them. Now, another thing, and of course, we're not accountants here or anything like that, but you're of the belief that get your own tax advice, but the value of the tag is $250.
And we have sold one tag sold for $250 in the online auction. So they've sold from everywhere from $250 to $20,500.
Okay.
When you purchase your tag, you're going to get a certificate of authenticity.
Okay.
You're also going to get a letter saying, thank you for your support of Delaware State Parks. Retail value of this is $250. You paid X amount. Please consult with your tax professional. There could be tax advantages to this relationship. So
right. So I'm just going to say, for example, this is just me thinking. Somebody buys this tag today, let's just say for $40,000. You got a $40,250. The $40,000, again, check with your tax accountant, but if that is a donation, that's got some great implications there of helping somebody tax-wise. So, can I keep this?
Absolutely.
I'll take a couple more if you got them, but if not, I'll get them there.
And our whole staff is intrigued to see what this tag goes for. We've heard everything from 40 to 50, and last Friday I was armed with Butch Emmerett, and he knows a thing or two about black and white tags, and he said he thought over 100,000.
Really?
So, I won't tell you he's on our payroll or anything like that.
Well, I would have just said, I received that bid, Butch. Do I have 101?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Anything else I need to know?
One more big event coming up after BBQ. Starting end of November, we're going to have a drive-through Christmas light show being done at Cape Henlopen State Park. It's going to be just under 3 miles. All sorts of, you know, tunnels and going to be a great family event. And then on weekends, you'll be able to stop at the ferry and there'll be a winter carnival with, you know, a form of ice skating, you know, bonfire, all sorts of great stuff. So,
will you be leading us in ice skating lessons?
I will not, I will be certainly going through and
saying thank you for coming.
Well, we've been talking about something like this for 3 years.
And, this is wonderful. Where are you getting all these ideas?
Well, this is one that we've partnered with the folks that run the Crooked Hammock and some great business support, and businesses have paid for this. They've sponsored this entire show. And then all the money raised is going to go back out to the community in grants in different ways. So it's a double win situation.
Oh, this is even these tags. I mean, you know, some people look at this and say, this is ridiculous. I would say look at this and be thankful of the people that are buying them because it does help your community. I mean, if you're a taxpaying citizen of Delaware, anybody that buys these tags is helping your tax situation.
At a $5 entrance into Cape Henlopen, imagine what tag number is going to go for, how many cars we would have to see to equal that same amount.
Right.
Or raise people's fees.
Yeah. Yep. So, all right, Ray, anything else?
That's it. Thanks for having me on.
Okay.
Look forward to seeing everyone. And please stop by and say hello to us at the 2:30 South Inlet Delaware Seashore State Park today. And BBQ is going on the whole day today.
Wow. Okay. All right. I'm going to thank you for your time. If you want to hang a little bit longer, we might get you back on. Do you have time?
Yeah, I got time.
Okay. All right. Well, then just stand by. So let's get Barry on. Barry from Dry Zone is here. He did not oversleep. I was just messing with him. Because his parents promised me they would wake him up. You don't live at home, do you?
No.
Okay,
no.
I was just messing with you. I'm trying to give you a hard time.
I moved out on my own last week.
Oh. Right before this show. And you woke up on time.
All by myself.
All right, anyway. Hey, was there a stock car race last night somewhere?
There was.
Where was that at?
Well, at US 113 Speedway.
Really? Did you go?
I was there.
Okay, it looked like a big crowd.
It was a huge, well, it was a large crowd and a huge camping crowd out front.
You're not using the word huge, are you?
No. Okay. It was a very big crowd, the exciting times out there.
I was coming home yesterday, I went by and I saw all them campers out there.
I'm my gosh.
There's something big going on here.
That was another thing that was happening out there.
Yeah. Well, good.
It was a good time.
All right. What is going on with Dry Zone?
We are fixing damaged basements and crawl spaces from all this storm stuff.
Okay.
And some of the things I brought in today was just, not only can we make waterproof your basement, but we can fix it if it's been damaged, or we can prevent it from being damaged.
Okay.
Different types of flooring.
So if you have damage, there's hope.
Yes. And then we can make it so that it won't happen again.
Can I ask you about these things?
Absolutely.
So this looks like maybe a 1 foot by 1 foot square.
Right.
I would call it a tile. So this would go down on your floor in a basement, like on a cement floor.
Absolutely.
All right. So what's all these little nubs on the back?
That lets it breathe so that it hits a thermal barrier. So, if you want to finish your basement and you want to go downstairs in your stocking feet, you don't get that shock when you touch the cold floor. It's nice and comfortable.
That is kind of neat. All right.
Another thing, it already
comes with the carpet on it?
It has a carpet, and that is a nylon base, so nothing's organic.
So that's a real carpet?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And non-organic.
Yep, so mold and mildew will not grow on that.
Isn't that something? Now, what if you wanted mold and mildew to grow?
Oh, well, I'm
then
sure
buy organic.
Buy regular stuff, and we'll come fix it again.
You don't mind doing the work twice?
No.
Okay. All right, and so this one has, what would I call that, vinyl?
It's a vinyl, but it looks...
Non-organic vinyl.
Non-organic vinyl.
Okay.
If you did have a pipe burst or something like that,
it's
easy to clean up.
It's not just storm damage.
No.
I keep thinking that all the time, but in other words, it's not just that. It could be a pipe bust, and what I guess that a lot of people are experiencing that never had a basement leak, all of a sudden they had a house in one area, and next thing you know, another house comes and another, and before you know it, this guy puts in a pool and so on, and all of a sudden... the basement starts leaking.
Absolutely. Yeah,
because the water movement has been changed. Yeah.
The house has gotten older. Mm-hmm. Water's going to win. It'll always find a way in.
I agree with that.
And then, some homeowners, like myself, you watch a YouTube video on how to fix a leaky pipe, and you go away on vacation, and you have an indoor pool when you come home. So we can now fix this stuff so that it doesn't happen again.
Now, if somebody just wants to talk about remodeling their basement,
Yes. They
just say, look, I don't even have a problem right now, but look, I'm interested in these products. I want to learn more about them. Mm-hmm. I want to touch them. I want to feel them. I want to see them.
Right.
You're going to come out and sit down with them, measure it up, and give them an idea of what it's going to be for this product completely installed turnkey.
Absolutely. We'll let them know exactly that day.
Okay. And there's also financing opportunities for these products, too?
Yeah. We have, no interest loans for a year. And we also have low interest loans on traditional financing.
I'd have to think about whether I want the no interest or the low interest. Okay. I have to weigh it out. I'm sure it has to do with credit scores and so on. So anyway, but do you also take credit cards?
We do. And we take cash and we take checks.
Oh, you're still taking cash?
We still take
cash. Okay. And checks. All right.
We check ID for cash, though. No, just kidding.
But you'll take anybody's credit card.
Right.
Isn't that funny? We're all laughing.
But we all, we'll take a combination. I mean, we've...
Oh, so you would take a little cash, little check, little credit card.
Whatever they
now,
want.
What if I've got a lot of bad checks that people gave me? And I called you up and said, hey, I got a whole box full of checks. I give you those?
I'll help you put them on a counter so we can get them seated publicly.
All right, so Dry Zone, good company. They know what they're doing. They stand behind what they sell. Mm-hmm. It's a thought-through process. It's not somebody just sitting there scratching their head saying, I think this will work.
Absolutely. It's all proven products. We're trained and we learn this product so that we can best serve you and install these good things.
Wow. So if somebody had questions, can they talk directly to you if they're watching right now and say, hey, he seems like a pretty nice guy?
Oh, absolutely. They can give me a call at 866-471-7962.
And I encourage people to call him now just to make sure that's the right phone number. So when you do need him, you'll be able to call him. But this is all forward thinking stuff. This is well worth sitting down and saying, what's involved? In other words, you know, I want to know. I want some idea of what I'm looking at. In other words, but I've met many people that have dealt with dry zone. I've dealt with dry zone before, during, and after the sale. It's all been a good experience.
Awesome.
The original quote, getting the packet in the mail. In other words, everything has just been a really good, positive experience for myself. And I've got a lot of people that have heard you on the show and told me they gave you a call and dealt with you. Some of them are still thinking about it. Mm-hmm. And but they enjoyed the whole experience all the way through. They didn't feel you were pushy. They felt you were knowledgeable. I said, well, just get to know him a little better.
There you go.
In other words, but they've enjoyed it. So, Barry, you're doing a good job. Dry Zone's doing a good job. And I encourage people, give them a call. What's that toll-free number?
866-471-7962.
Have you got it memorized?
I do.
866-471-7962.
And
all right, call Barry right now and just say good morning, okay?
We'll take care of it.
All right, and you'll reply to that remorning.
Absolutely.
All right, good morning. So anyway, dryzone.com. I forgot the website almost.
Or visit us out there at the Big
Red
Barn.
Oh, Route 16 in Ellendale. Big Red Barn, white roof. That's
right.
You've got a beautiful showroom. Yeah, they actually use it. Well, they had a water pipe bus there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
so we had to waterproof ourselves.
Yeah, there you go. All right, thanks, Barry. Have a good day. Are you going to the auction?
I am not. I'm getting ready to go do a visit over western side of St. Michael's called Nivette.
Really?
Like that.
Do you have a credit card?
I do.
Okay. Because I can help you purchase something today, and you don't even have to be there.
I know. I can hear you.
Okay. All right.
I'm looking for a 40-digit tag that's coming up.
You really?
Well, I've got...
What's the number, Barry?
I can't remember the number right now, but it's...
I'll buy it and resell it to you.
Right.
Just to help you out.
I got the original red tag from 1982.
That's
the year I graduated, and it was on my parents' truck. Actually, I got a whole bunch of those series. But
you finally graduated.
I did. It took a while.
1982. They held a party, didn't they?
Oh, boy.
Barry's going. All right. Anything else?
That's it.
He can't get out of here quick enough. All I wanted was his credit card info.
No,
what?
It's a 2-hour drive still to where I'm going.
He's got to go, folks. Thanks for stopping by, Barry. All right. What's that number again? 866-471-7962. Call him now, would you? And call me, too, to guess how much all that stuff adds up to. Are you leaving us?
Where's all that stuff?
It's right there in the box. It's amazing. Would you like to guess? Here, say it on mic. So Brandon can write it down.
$299.
Now, is that $299 or $2.99?
But would a $1 bid win? Price over, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Like, Price is Right.
Who knows?
All right,
thanks a lot. All right, next, we got a lot going on here. We are getting further behind, but every time I talk to Barry, it makes me think about insurance. My insurance company, L&W Insurance Agency, Bill Strickland and his team, they do a good job for me, and they've been in business since 1932. That's amazing. But they serve all of Delaware, and they do a good job. They sell auto insurance, home, health, life, commercial coverage, whatever you may need. I do like this. I know it doesn't seem like a big deal, but it does to me. When I call during normal business hours, I get a live human being, and they answer the phone, and I say, can I talk to so-and-so? And they'll say, yep, let me switch you right over. Nope, they're out to lunch. Would you like somebody else? Instead of just dumping me over to a voicemail. I like that. I know that doesn't seem like a big thing, but when I need to talk to my insurance company, I need to talk to my insurance company. So anyway, they have a live, friendly person answer the phone, one of the largest independent agencies in Delaware. They represent you, the policyholder, not the insurance company. And people say, what does that mean? What does that mean? Well, what it means is if you need them, they'll give you more than one quote. So if you want some insurance prices, if you have insurance, you want to get a second opinion, no problem at all. But when you have a claim, this is where the rubber meets the road. In other words, they get involved. They work between you and the insurance company to make sure you're satisfied with how things work out. I meet so many people that will buy insurance maybe on a 1-800 number or something like that, and over the internet, and then when they need it, then they find out why it was so cheap. So you want to think about that. good insurance is good, but great service is priceless. So if you need insurance, I recommend L&W Insurance Agency. You got nothing to lose by giving them a call, telling them what insurance you have, double check, make sure you got the right amounts, make sure you got the right deductible, and if they can do a better job for you, then let them, and if not, just learn from it what you can. So their phone number is 856-7828, 856-7828, and it's LW Insurance. .com on the web. You give them a call, tell them I sent you, they'll take good care of you. I did mention earlier that our calendars are in and out and ready for you to pick up. The store's opening early on Saturdays right now. We're opening at 8 o'clock. I'm sure they're open by now, so if you'd like a calendar, just stop in and pick one up. They are all ready to go, and they are free for the taking, and they're brand new 2017 calendars. I don't remember how many we got. I think 500, but they always do go pretty quick. So if you want one, just ask them for one. All right, we're going to continue on with the show. I'm going to have Ray back on after 8 o'clock just to wrap up a few things. But I also wanted to let you know that we have this box. We've had a tremendous amount of phone calls today. And this box is full of stuff. Brandon, can you stick it up here real quick and lay it on its side or something so people can see it? But anyway, this box has got 77 items in it, and it's going to be given away free, okay? So there's 77 items, and all you have to do is dial 337-7300 and say, hey, I think those items add up to this. Pull a few of them out, hold them up, stack them on top of the box, whatever you need. I feel like Dave Wilson here at the auction, in other words. Get it out, hold it up, and show it. I always ask Dave, I said, does it work? He said, it did when it was new. But anyway, just letting you know, all these items work, especially the rat trap. So anyway, you get this entire box of items free. We've had a lot of phone calls. All you have to do is guess how much money we would sell all this for in the store, and you win the entire box of stuff free. There's 77 things in there, okay? Does not include delivery. Brandon will not deliver it, and nor will we ship it. You've got to come in the store and pick it up, okay? All right, so that's that. Calendars are free. Store is open. Got a lot of stuff going on. And what is next, Mr. Brooks Ritter? I did talk to Barry from Dry Zone, did I not?
You did, yes.
Have I talked about Mid-South Audio?
You have not.
Okay, well, Mid-South Audio does all kinds of things. In other words, Mid-South Audio goes out to events like an auction or a concert or a parade or anything in between, and they will set up. They will set up a stage. They have platforms that go on the stage. They bring all the speakers and the microphones and the wires and the amplifiers and the soundboards, and they can let you run it or they can run it for you. They also have crowd control barriers. They also have those things that you put on the ground that the wires go through so cars can drive over them and people don't trip over the wires. But they do it all. They have it all. They rent it all, or they sell it all. So if you happen to need any of those things, you give them a call. That's whether you're putting on like a concert or an auction, or you're having a party at your house and you just need a small portable PA sound system. They also have that, or they'll bring you whatever you may need, a wrestling match or who knows what. We ought to have some kind of an event here someday that we bring them out and do something. Maybe we'll have karaoke at Weller's, okay? So if you buy a trailer, you can sing the blues. But anyway, Mid-South Audio has it all. They also have, in Georgetown, a full-blown recording studio. So if you want to record something, if you want to record a song or a jingle or whatever, they can help you with that. And then it was like a room right next to it, I remember, full of all kinds of instruments. So if you either need somebody to play those instruments to create the music, or if you have people that want to come, you can use their instruments. So anyway, it's Mid-South Audio. I can't describe everything they do. If you go to their website, midsouthaudio.com, there's also a really neat video there too. So give them a call, 856-6993. Or check them out on the web at MidSouthAudio.com. And again, the number is 856-6993. If you don't have any idea of whether they can do or will do what you need done, you give them a call and Kevin will help you out. All right, we are here. We are live. Weller's Utility Trailers is open. We've had a very busy week. There is something that we did. When did we start this? Back in August, I think. We put some trailers on sale. Little experiment. We've had a challenging year, but we want to finish it strong. Put these trailers on sale, had a phenomenal August. Roll right into the next month, had another good month. So now we've put more trailers on sale. So if you haven't checked us lately, check us now at Wellers.com. We're going to take a break from the radio. We're going to be right back with more radio, but we're going to continue right on here on the stream, on TV, and everywhere in between. So folks that are watching right now, I want to take another minute and mention Walls Service Center, downtown Milford. You say, where is Milford? Milford is where the Kent and Sussex County line is, okay? It goes right through downtown Milford, the Mississippian River. So one side of it, the current's going one way, that's Sussex County. The other side of the river, the current's going the other way, that is called Kent County. So in other words, you can tell by the difference in the water. I don't know if there's a big illuminated line down the center. I'm not sure. But anyway,
I think it's
Milford.
Dashed.
It's what?
I think it's like a dash line.
Like on the center of the road or something like that?
Yeah.
Okay, so anyway, the Mississippian River is where Kent and Sussex County divide. And Walls Service Center is right downtown Milford. So if you need something as simple as an oil change, or you are getting ready to go through inspection, and you just want to make sure that your brake lights and turn signals and everything works and that your wipers are good, you can stop in for that, and they'll do that right on the spot for you. If you need wipers, of course, they charge to replace them, but pretty much to look at everything is no charge, so you don't get all the way down or all the way up to the inspection lane and find out, oh my goodness, I got a tail light out and I didn't even know it. So anyway, they also do oil changes. They do things like brakes and rotors, exhaust. A lot of people, you know, if you got a muffler leaking or something like that, an exhaust leak, sometimes, you know, just the exhaust system rusts out in time. Or you got a newer vehicle and you say, man, I want to get a dual exhaust system put on, something custom. Or you're fixing up an old car or something like that. Whatever you may need exhaust work done on, they can do. They definitely work on automotive air conditioners too. But it's a good time to get your antifreeze checked. Make sure it's right so nothing's out of whack there. If you need an oil change, they check all that stuff at the same time. So it's Walls Service Center. Where are they located? It's downtown Milford, 220 Northeast Front Street. Been in business 58 years. Locally owned, locally operated. Phone number's 422-8110, 422-8110. On the web, you can go to wallsservicecenter.com and actually request an appointment, you know, to get something worked on. All right, so that is Walls Service Center, and they are a good place to deal. I deal with them. I'm happy with them. Their prices are fair. They'll give you an idea of what you're looking at before the job, so there's no big surprises afterwards. And that's all I have to say about them. But they do have a couple nice restaurants in the neighborhood, too. All right, the next thing we want to talk about is what, Mr. Ritter? We have a lot of things to hit. We're going to talk with Ray Bivens some more here in a few minutes about these tags. You said you would allow me to put number one on your van.
Absolutely.
And you feel that you can go on the beach if you get up enough speed entering the beach. It's beyond that point that you think you're going to be stuck. Is that right?
Probably, yes.
Okay.
But at least it'd be a van stuck with the tag number, a surf fishing tag number one on it.
Yes, so yeah. The wrecker man knows who to send the bill to. All right. What else have you got for me?
Oh, well, I did want to mention our Facebook pages.
Oh, yes, they're building momentum. I want to mention something to you.
Sure.
What's the one that we have that has surf fishing tags on it?
Delaware Low Digit Surf Tags.
So that's on Facebook?
Yes.
So we would like people to like that page.
Absolutely.
I need you to put a picture of a tag on there.
Which number?
I don't know, 22.
22?
Okay. What?
I feel like
anyway.
It's already on there.
Okay. Oh, I thought there was a blank spot. All right, you look it up and see. You might be right. I might be wrong. Brooks is the guru when it comes to all our websites because that's where this conversation started. But you're saying you'd like people to like that page, and then you would like people to like Weller Sheds and Carports. That's the one Brandon keeps an eye on. Then there's Weller's Utility Trailers, and then there's Weller Does Delmarva, and then, of course, you can be my friend on Facebook, the Facebook. Is there a picture there or not?
Absolutely.
No way.
Yeah.
Hold on. You're telling me, what's the name of the website? What? It's not a website.
It's a Facebook
page.
Delaware Low Digit Surf Tags. It's a Facebook
page. And so there's a profile picture there.
That's what you want the profile picture to be 20. I got you.
Folks, I work with this man every day. This is what I'm saying. Yes. Isn't there a blank spot?
Yes, folks. I work with this man every day, too.
Okay, so what are you saying? There is a blank spot. Insert picture here.
Yeah, it's there. It's 22. I don't know what you're talking about. If you look at it,
hold on. You keep talking while I'm going to look this up. What am I looking up again? I'm on Facebook, everybody. This is live also, just so you know. This isn't rehearsed. All right, Delaware. Delaware low-digit surf tags. You're absolutely right. Did you do this recently?
Can I plead the fifth?
Would somebody bring this up to you already?
No, I just did it as we were talking.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, man, I had people say, there's not a picture up there. So go there, folks. And I've got a lot of tags. Now, I personally buy these tags as an investment. So I hope to make some money by buying them and then reselling them. Because they're going to run out someday because there's only so many numbers to be purchased. All right. So thank you for doing that, Brooks. No so problem. Did I mention all of the Facebook pages?
You did not.
What did I miss?
We got Weller Does Delmarva. We didn't actually mention them. We just started talking about
them. Weller Does Delmarva.
Weller's Utility Trailers.
Okay.
Jim Weller. That's Jim Weller from Delaware.
Yeah, not Alaska.
Yep. Weller's Sheds and Carports and Delaware Low Digit Surf Tags.
Wow, that's a lot of them.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so we're asking people to either friend us or like those pages, please.
That's correct.
All right. Do we have anything else we want them to do? Come in and spend some money?
Absolutely.
Hey, have you ever heard the phone ring this much? I say this every time we have a little contest. But, Brandon, you may not know about this, but we need an answer by 8:45.
He's working on it. We're going to probably get your phone, too, to make sure nothing went into your voicemail.
But, yeah, it's 337-7300. Don't call past 8:45. But we are going to figure out who guessed, and we're going to give you this whole box of junk. I mean, Jules, this whole box of stuff that we have prepared for you, okay? Do want to just make sure everybody understands if you would just call and give a guess how much it is. If you happen to guess more than once, we'll just take their first guess, okay? So that's that. Now, we're going to talk about the surf fishing tag auction again here in just a few minutes. I'm kind of excited about it. It's going to be a big event, so if you're listening and you're looking for something to do today, it's going to be worth your time just to go down there and watch this, even if you don't want to buy anything. And we got our calendars in, and we got a lot of stuff on sale, too, here lately. I'm kind of surprised at how many different ads. We have a lot of used trailers that we've gotten in. I'll tell you about the ones that are in the ad. I'm just not positive what we have left. We have a nice little 5 foot wide, 8 foot long tilt bed trailer for $300. I didn't even think you could buy a trailer that cheap. $300 if you happen to want something like that. And then we have like a 6x12 enclosed trailer for like $1,997. You're saying, well, where are you reading that at, Jim? Go to Wellers.com and click on where it says current ads, and it will be right there. We back on the radio?
We are back on the radio.
We are on the radio. Okay, let's get Ray over here one more time, and we'll just go a couple more minutes talking about the big tag auction, the BBQ event, and everything in between. I need one of those flyers, too, if I could.
Do it from you.
All right, I'm going to keep it. Anyway, Ray, what else you got to tell us? Here's your mic.
Sure.
Oh, what, you got something else?
So today, we've been talking about this for a year. They're going to be a raffle drawn. There's a small 125cc gas-powered Jeep.
Really?
Delaware State Parks was selected as America's Best Managed State Parks by the National Academy of Parks and Recreation. And,
really? That sounds like a big award.
It is. And it's
congratulations.
It's their 65th anniversary. And,
gosh.
So all that's decked out on this Jeep, as you can see there, and it's a raffle.
That is really neat.
So that Terry McGee from McGee Motors donated that Jeep, and every dollar that comes in goes into an endowment to support getting kids connected to our state park. So,
how nice. McGee Motors.
McGee Motors. Yep.
Thank you very much,
Terry.
So
you Terry. Can get, I think it's one ticket for $5 or three for 10, and they'll be sold right there today at
when's the drawing?
I think it's at 3:30 today. It's right
after
the surf tag.
Oh, today they're going to know the winner.
Yep, after the surf tag auction, we'll know the winner. All sorts of great stuff to do at today's events for kids. It's only $5 a person to get into the barbecue event.
Wow.
There's blow-ups, there's rides, there's face painting.
So this is like a family-friendly, get out here and have a good time. It's rain or shine either way, but come on down.
And the first event today kicks off at 9. There's a fun run and walk. Across the Indian River Bridge, if you've never had a chance to do that. They're taking registration up to 8:45.
I have walked across the bridge. Have you?
It's beautiful.
Isn't it?
Yes. So
it's a great place to take pictures, too.
Absolutely.
And it really looks neat at nighttime and so on. And you see all the water just churning and swaling and the boats. And
I can't tell you how many pictures I see of our campers at night. They're staring up at the bridge, and that blue, it's kind of glowing. It's a fantastic spot.
Mm-hmm. I agree. And you can walk across it from either side?
Either side.
Okay.
And
meaning not north and southbound.
But this is, I believe, the only official race And it's Halloween themed, so there'll be people there in costumes and everything else.
This is a big day.
Yeah, it's a fantastic one. We're glad.
Starting at 9 o'clock.
We're glad the weather's going to cooperate. The rain's getting out of here. It's going to be about 59, 60 degrees and a little windy, but when is it not windy down
right,
by the
Right, but
Indian
you won't
River
be sweating to death.
No, that's for sure. So,
how long have they been selling tickets on that Jeep?
About 10 months. So this,
wow,
today's the day.
Today is the day. I'm excited. This is going to be a good time.
Yeah, I'm looking forward.
There's food to be bought.
Plenty of food. The barbecue's amazing.
Bring your kids. Plenty of things. You're saying the $5, the rides don't cost extra?
No, there's different things for different rides, like the moon bounce and things like that.
Okay.
But they're all affordably priced. And,
wow.
The tags, it's very interesting. I'm can't wait to see.
Right, even if you just go to watch the tag auction.
Oh, that's entertainment enough, I would think.
Yeah, so $5 to get in. All right, anything else?
That's it. Number one and 12 other tags today. Please, if you're thinking about buying a tag, this is your best chance. Come out, and you got pretty much choice of everything.
I would say this is like
very
a smorgasbord.
Few numbers that, unless it's taken and it's very low, or if it's very low, you can get all the way up to 10,000 today.
Is there a website we could steer people to?
Yep. If you go to destateparks.com, you can go on there and you can follow all of our low digit tag stuff. It shows what's been sold.
Okay.
There'll be a nice program like this handed out at the event. About the only thing you can't do is camp today.
Okay.
Because it's totally booked out. But if you think, hey, I'd like to, for BBQ next year, make your reservation early.
Get that reserved
both
now.
Both sides of the inlet are totally full, which
Isn't
is a great
something?
Thing. So
good day. All right, I'm going to leave you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks so
Did
much.
You have a good time?
Yeah, absolutely. Appreciate
it. All right. Don't forget this tag.
I was about to walk out.
You can leave it. Right? I'll bring it down, or it'll be on Brooks's van. All right, everybody. This is a great event. I'm going to encourage you. If you're down there, look me up. I should be the short, bald-headed guy, unless there's more than one short, bald-headed guy down there. But anyway, it's a good day. It's a good event. I'm excited about it. So what is next? I got a lot of ads to catch up on, don't I?
Yes, First Class Heating and Air.
First Class Heating and Air, great company to deal with. I'm very happy with them. Again, folks, as you listen to me do these ads, I do need to make sure you know I deal with all these companies. I know them personally, and I'm very pleased with their service, and I don't mind endorsing them. And First Class Heating and Air, another great company that I have done business with time and time again. I have a lot of properties and rental properties and things like that, and I've had heating and air conditioning systems put in. I've had them look at my house and do a plumbing inspection recently and learned a little bit from that also. So they offer plumbing, they offer home performance, they offer heating and air, they offer service contracts, and they're just a great company to deal with. So if you're listening and you say, look, my heater didn't work just right last year, but I got through the winter, but this year I want to make sure it's right. I want it to be as efficient as possible. And who do you call? Who do you trust? Well, I call First Class Heating and Air, and I do trust them. They have actually been serving Delaware and Maryland now for over 40 years. So it's a nice company. It's family owned and locally owned and operated. They do offer 24/7 emergency service if you need it. They do background and drug test all of their employees. They're wearing uniforms, their vehicles are lettered, and they are a first class company. If you do happen to buy one of their maintenance agreements and need any parts or repairs, you do get a discount from that. Also, they also offer financing. So I've got two or three projects they're getting ready to do for me, and I'll be talking more about them when I get them done. But one of them is just simply in our living room. My wife wants another thing put in where heat will come out. She says it's only on this one wall, and she wants another one on another wall, and they're looking at it, and they're going to be able to do all that, which will give me a little more heat in my living room. So anyway, there's many options, many things they have to offer, many things they can do. So give them a call, and it's 934-8900, 934-8900, and the name of the company is First Class Heating and Air. Great company. Local company, good people. So anyway, and they do all kinds of stuff, so give them a call. And their website, very informative. It's the words firstclasshvac.com. There's a customer testimonials there, and there's just all kinds of information. So again, 934-8900, firstclasshvac.com on the web. Brooks Ritter, I am definitely running behind today, am I not? I would like to say, though, Brooks has made up this really nice sheet of paper that I don't know if you could see it or not, but it has all the little times on it and everything. And I'm like, man, this is organized. Now I just need the training to follow this piece of paper.
Exactly. I was going to say, all we got to do is keep you on the times, and we'll be good to go.
You've done a wonderful job with that. I mean, he's broke it right down to the minute. So, and I guess in radio and TV world, every minute matters because that's how they sell it, by the minute.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we got the calendars out. People are just beating down the doors for those things. Is that right? All they had to do was push it open.
Exactly.
So anyway, but we got the calendars, and we got a lot of trailers on sale, and just a lot of stuff is happening here at Weller's. So I do want to say thank you to our customers. We're going to finish the year very strong, and it's kind of encouraging. We have a lot of people that have bought, what, two trailers, four trailers? Some has probably bought five or six from
Absolutely.
Us over the
yeah.
years. I mean, in other words, that's kind of nice. But what happens is you buy a little landscape trailer, and then all of a sudden you decide you want an enclosed trailer. And then before you know it, you might want a dump trailer. And then them aluminum ones catch your eye. And then say, man, I want one of them aluminum trailers too while we're at it. So many people that buy trailers do end up with more than one.
That's correct.
All right, Brooks, what is the next thing I need to talk about? Did I talk about Mid-South Audio?
You did, yes.
Don't they do a great job?
They do an excellent job.
I mean, just the things we have done business with them on here for Weller Does Delmarva. They really do a good job. So what is the next thing we want to talk about? We talked about you can watch the show later on at WellerDoesDelmarva.com, right?
That's correct, yes.
They also can go back on Facebook and watch it too, can't they?
They sure can.
Okay. So if you are listening and you said, man, I'd like to advertise on that show, well, first of all, we have to do some business, I guess. You know, because I do like it to be people that I do business with. But can I take just a minute and talk about Eagles Nest Church?
Absolutely.
All right. I don't know where we're at on the schedule, but next week's show, I also want to mention we are going to be down at Rehoboth. If you'd like to just come down and be part of our live audience, maybe we should have presents or prizes for the live audience. I don't know. I have to think about that one, okay? But anyway, if you want to be part of our live audience, you can. We're going to be right at where the Rehoboth Beach Public Library is. We're going to do the show there from 7 to 9, and then Colin Walls is going to be there because he is going to be doing all of the work to make the parade be on TV. So, WRDE. But Eagles Nest Church happens to be the church I go to. I'm very happy with them. My wife and I have been going there. I don't even know exactly how long, but I'm thinking like 15 years. It seems like forever. But anyway, Eagles Nest is a nice family-friendly church, kind of come as you are, very into the kids. So in other words, Jenny and Jason go, and I've got three grandkids that, you know, by Jenny and Jason, and they go, and they really love it. But they have even just like a nursery. So if you have a child that's just a few weeks old or whatever, you can bring that child for the nursery. Then from like up to fifth grade, they have what's called Kids Cove. Amy Brown does a great job with those kids there. And my grandkids always come away very excited and had a good time. And then after fifth grade, we start with sixth grade up into, you know, the high school years. They have what's called 220. And that's Matt Windsor. And he also does a good job with the kids there. So they don't mix them all together. They break them all out by age, and it makes it a little bit better. So safety is of a big concern there at Eagles Nest. In other words, we know that matters to parents nowadays. So you got this little name badge, and you got to have the one to match it. And there's just certain little things they have in place to make moms and dads feel very safe and secure when it comes to their kids' environment. But each, I don't know exactly how often it changes, but every so often, Pastor Bob does a series. And right now, the series is about the game of life. And life is like one big game. It's also like a big, long roller coaster ride. You have ups, and you have downs, and you have everything in between. And Eagles Nest is a church that's very welcoming, very friendly, very connected to the community. We like to go out and about and do things. You know, there's a lot of people have a perception of churches that the churches only want something from you. We actually are trying to do the opposite. We're trying to actually, you know, say we're created to serve, so we're here to serve our community. We're out and about, and we try to do things. We have different events. We actually have one coming up, which I believe is next. When is October 31st? What day is that on?
It's a Monday.
That's a Monday. So October 31st is our trunk or treat, 6:30 to 8, a very family-friendly, safe environment for you to come out with the kids and, you know, trick-or-treat in a well-lit, safe, secure environment. And that is on the 31st. So mark your calendar if you would. And I believe next Saturday I'm going to be joined by Amy Brown, who's going to talk about that. But Eagles Nest is, again, a very family-oriented church, lots of things going on, wants to get out in the community and do things and serve and be community active. So they have a belief, you know, the church is technically just a building. It's the people of the church that make the difference and will make a difference in the community. So Eagle's Nest, where in the world is it? It's on 26633-26633 Zion Church Road in Milton. Phone number 684-3149, 684-3149. On the web, it's eaglesnest.ch. And then on Facebook and Twitter, it's eaglesnestch. So it's kind of neat how they got all those names coordinated. So anyway, check them out. I will be there tomorrow morning. Saturday nights are 6:30 and Sunday mornings are 9:30. Everybody is welcome. Pretty much come as you are. Fellowship with us at Eagle's Nest, all right? Now, what is next? We're going to talk to Brandon, or am I going to just keep rolling?
We're going to talk to Brandon.
We're going to talk to Brandon. All right, Brandon is open. He has been busy. Have you had any phone calls yet, Brandon?
I have not had any phone
calls.
No phone
calls yet.
All right. I have a few up in the showroom, though.
All right, well, he needs calls on his cell phone, preferably not in the middle of the night, but any time is fine with him. What is it again?
302-542-7794.
All right, so we're just needing somebody to call him just so he knows people are listening and that they care. All right, what do you got going on? What are you going to talk about next?
What do you want to talk about?
I want to talk about that aluminum trailer out
there. All right,
let's because,
talk about that one.
We didn't go outside because it was raining, but we had this trailer out there. So the first segment, we talked about them hallmarks, 7x14 for, what was it, $42.99?
That's correct.
Okay. Now, I don't know if that's an ongoing price, but it's on sale for that. Is that right?
That's correct.
Okay. But these open trailers, what have you got out there? A 6x10?
Yes, I have a 6x10.
Landscaping.
Landscaping trailer. It's going to have a all-aluminum frame.
Okay.
Has a treated wood floor.
Okay.
15-inch tires, A-frame.
That's nice. Comes with a jack.
Comes with a jack.
Okay.
It has what's called a two-way ramp gate.
Well, hold on. So the frame is all aluminum. So this trailer is a lightweight trailer.
Very lightweight.
Have you personally picked up the tongue?
I have. I was placing them outside to be ready for the show today, but the rain has graced us.
Because we were going to kind of show them what the picking up the tongue of a steel trailer versus an aluminum.
Yes, and I can pick it up with one hand.
Oh, my gosh. All right. And
that is absolutely saying a lot. Just want you all to know that.
You're funny.
Anyway, I going to ask you? Now, you said it's got a two-way ramp gate. What does that mean?
Basically, what that means is the ramp gate will lay down like a normal ramp gate. So you can drive
flops up. Down so you can drive your four-wheeler up or lawnmower or whatever.
But it also lays down inside of the bed of the trailer. So if you're
why would I even want that?
Well, if you were going to like a big box store and you say, "Oh, I need 16-foot lumber, but I only have a 10-foot trailer."
Ooh, good point. What if it's a little box store?
It could be a little box store if you want.
Okay,
a box store.
A box store.
A lumber yard.
All right. Well, how about a lumber yard and forget the box store?
There you go.
But anyway.
And some people use them to haul brush and stuff. And so if you lay down that ramp.
Or a couch.
You can utilize a little bit more of an overhang length versus just a 10-foot.
Or otherwise that gate would be right in your way, sticking straight up.
Right. And then some people, if you can't lay the gate down, and they're forced to either
try to
lay the merchandise
up in the air,
the ramp, and it sticking up in the air, or pointing up into towards their vehicle and risk damaging the vehicle.
Wow, that's kind of neat because not all trailers are that way.
No.
Is the ramp gate aluminum also?
It is.
I bet that is feather light.
Yes, it is very light.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's a very, very, very light trailer. And just, you know, you can wheel it all the way around. Very easy to use. 6x10. Like I said, treated wood floor.
Now, this is a brand new trailer. I mean, this is a brand called Carry On, which we sell a lot of their trailers. But they've not built aluminum trailers before. So this is brand new, brand new.
Brand new, brand new.
And the thing is, when you think of aluminum, because we sell a brand called Aluma also.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you think of an Aluma 10-foot trailer, you think of what, $3,000, $3,200, something like that?
Yeah, at minimum,
At minimum, okay. This one here, we did get a special deal on them, right? What do we have, 6x10 and 6x12?
Correct.
But I think we've got it on sale, am I reading this right, for $19.99?
That is correct.
$1,999, folks, for a 6x10 aluminum landscape trailer.
Right.
That's the deal.
That's the deal, and there's only one.
Oh, there is only one left?
The 6x10.
They just came in the other
day. They just came in, yeah.
Wow. All right. All right. Well, anyway, then just a normal 6x10 landscaper, which would be a steel frame trailer and a steel ramp gate.
Correct.
Okay. We've got them on sale for, what is that?
$1,249.
Okay. So that's pretty much the best bang on the shore.
Right.
All right. So we got the deals. We got the selection. And that's one of the things that people really like when they get here. They're like, I was reading an ad and this guy had this price and that guy had that, but I can't tell nothing by the ad.
Right.
They get here and they're like, okay, let's just run through in a 6x10 landscape trailer. How many choices are there? You would start with a normal basic trailer for $1,249. Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. Then you can get that same brand trailer, and except the top rail was a pipe top.
Top. Yep.
Then you can get another brand where it's all box tubing.
Yep.
Where instead of having one rail, it has two rails, and the sides are even higher.
And all and the entire framing is box tubing.
Okay, all powder coated paint job. Then you can get a 6x10 with 16-inch high wire mesh sides.
That's correct.
Then you can get one with 24-inch high wire mesh sides.
Right.
Then you can get this aluminum one.
Yep.
And then you also can get an aluminum one. Did I miss anything?
No, that covered pretty much all.
What a variety, though.
That's seven different styles of a 6x10.
How many brands of trailers is that? That's Carry-On, Master Tow, and Aluma.
And Aluma.
So that represents three brands of trailers. Mm-hmm. And that is what we're trying to say, folks. If you are thinking about buying a trailer, we know price is important, but we've never met a deal that we can't handle. In other words, we're not going to be undersold. But more importantly than price, let's get you the right trailer.
Right.
In other words, just like this aluminum trailer, if you got a smaller vehicle, it's going to be a lot easier on the vehicle pulling an aluminum trailer. Plus, an aluminum trailer will haul a bigger payload than a steel trailer because the trailer weighs less.
Correct. Yep.
Okay. So there's lots of advantages.
Yeah,
there.
We have a wide variety of options here for you, and it makes it easier for us to get you in the trailer that you need.
But we also will spend time with you.
Right. Absolutely.
You said the word big box store.
Yeah.
Try finding somebody to spend time with you there.
Yeah,
go out in the parking lot, walk around, talk to you about trailers.
I had a gentleman over the course of 3 days. I spent about 2 to 3 hours with him,
helping him.
Making sure he's getting
the right trailer
for
the right price,
for
the right need.
And it happened to be one of those scenarios where the equipment that he was hauling, based on the weight that he was telling me he was hauling, the trailer he was wanting wasn't capable.
Right.
And so we really...
But somewhere else would have just let him buy that trailer.
Correct. So we really, really spent the time to make sure he got the right trailer, the right size, the right width, the right weight rating and everything.
We pride ourselves on that.
We do.
In other words, a good price is important, but good service is priceless.
Absolutely.
So, all right. So Weller's Utility Trailers is located on Route 13 in Bridgeville. What are we open? Monday through Friday.
9 to 5.
And Saturday?
Is 8 to 1.
8 to 1. All right.
And during the radio show.
During the radio show.
Yeah,
all right. Opened early. All right. 337-8228. And if you want to call Brandon directly, you are, 542-7794?
Yep, that's me.
Your phone has not rang yet. I'm surprised.
It probably
but anyway.
Is ringing. I have got it on.
Oh, well, okay. I will say the other phone is ringing for our contest. Have you been keeping track of the guesses?
I have been keeping track of the guesses.
Okay, so you've got quite a few there.
We do.
We have one that will win. I don't know. You don't know the number, do you?
I don't know the number.
There's the number.
Oh, yeah.
So no, we don't have a winner. We do have a winner.
We have one very, very close.
We sure do, don't
very,
we?
Very close.
All right, folks. No, that one won't win. It's over.
Oh, that is over.
The third one down there will win because it's under.
It is.
There's still time, folks. You've got till 8:45 to make your last guess.
So, but what we're saying is there is going to be a winner.
And now there is. It's game on, buddy. It's game on. There's going to be a winner for sure because somebody has guessed right now a number that's close enough. You didn't see that on TV, did you, the numbers? Okay.
That's why I was holding it
okay.
this way.
Anyway, I forgot we're streaming this and on TV and everything else. So anyway, somebody's going to win 337-7300. I'm going to cut you loose, but I want you to lay all that stuff back out on the table for me, all right?
Okay.
It's 77 items. 77 items that you can win for free. So you're going to say, well, how much is it? It's free. How much is the box that it's in? It's free. We're just doing this for fun, okay? In other words, this is not how we make our living, all right? We do not make our living giving away things free. But it's 337-7300. We've had a lot of phone calls. And if you would just guess how much it adds up to, you may be the winner. We do have somebody right now that has guessed a number. It's lower than the amount, but guess the amount or lower, and closest to the amount wins. All right, Brooks, I think that was a very complicated contest we've come up with.
We're good at making hoops.
That is pretty simple.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's a mess of stuff, ain't it?
It is a lot of stuff.
I mean, I see 20 packs of tissues, what, a dozen pair of socks, rat traps. Look at these ink pens. There's like packs of these things in there. That little notebook thing, the leather thing for carrying two bottles of wine. What is that, a little truck? Oh, that's a cup, a NASCAR cup with a T-shirt in it. And a little a Zag cleaning kit, which is like for cleaning all your electronic devices. It's kind of neat, isn't it?
And that stuff works really well. Just
oh, it does. Yeah. Bob Backman endorses it. Okay? I gave him one, and he loves it. So anyway, it's 337-7300. All you're doing is guessing a dollar amount, what you think these 77 items add up to. And if you guess the closest to the amount without going over, you win the whole box full of stuff, okay? So if you are listening on the radio, we're going to take a break from the radio in just a minute. And you can now switch over to Facebook Live or MyCozy TV, which is Comcast 204, Mediacom 99, on the air at 31.2. Or you can watch us at Weller Does Delmarva, too. So anyway, all of those things will get the job done. Now, what is the next thing that I need to talk about? Because I am definitely falling a little bit behind. Would you agree?
Just a little bit. You almost caught up, and then you got behind again.
Got behind. Brandon messed me up. But Brandon's doing a good job. They got these Brandon spoiler alerts. That's been going pretty good. Are we taking the break from the radio now so I can relax?
Well, no, you gotta keep talking.
We're
still on TV.
All right. So anyway, we're still on TV. So if you are watching on MyCozy TV, I really would love to hear from you, okay? I would like to know, where are you watching from? Now, every time I do this, people say, I'm on my pontoon boat watching on TV, or I'm in the kitchen, or something like that. What I'm asking is whereabouts are you watching from? If you're in Maryland, we'd really love to hear what county, what part of Maryland you're watching from, or Delaware. Some people are actually watching from who knows where. So the phone number to just tell us where you're watching from is 337-7300. Should we give them something just for telling us that? What could we give you? How about, we'll answer it live. Call me right now. We'll take a live phone call, by golly. And if you own a business, we're going to give you a free business plug, too. So it's 337-7300. If you call right now, we're going to put you on the air, and you could tell us who you are and where you're from, and we just want to know where you're watching from. 337-7300. Don't be shy. Give me a call. My goodness. Somebody's calling, believe it or not. I'm on the blue mic. Are you ready? Caller, you're going to need to turn down your volume on your TV. Here we go. All right, you're live on TV. Good morning.
Good morning. This is Ben Lindgren. I'm listening to you guys over in Angola, Lewis, post office box.
Wow. And how are...
24. Love it. Keep going.
All right. And what are you doing today?
I'm staying out of trouble. I'm 82, so I'm doing as little as possible.
Wow.
It's raining around here, so I cut grass just to keep myself alive and moving.
Okay.
That's it.
What was your name again?
Ben.
Ben. Well, thank you, Ben. And do you watch often, or is this your first time?
It's my first time, and I got more junk than you guys have. I don't need a thing.
You want us to bring the show to your place and help you get rid of your junk? We'll just have a big yard sale flea market.
No, thank you.
All right. Thanks a lot. Have a good weekend. Thanks for the call. Bye. That was nice, wasn't it? Yeah, I had another call. So if you want to call and be on live, just tell us where you're calling from and what you think of the show. 337-7300. I think we can squeeze one more caller in. That was really nice. First time watching the show, or first time calling. I can't remember what he said. So I get so nervous when I talk to like a live audience. Okay, like I can talk through all this stuff, no problem. But when I got him one-on-one, 337-7300. If you would like to be on live, and if you own a business, we'll let you throw in a free plug too. All right. Or if you have a gift you want to give away. All right. So anyway, Weller Does Delmarva next week is going on the road. We are going to be downtown Rehoboth, and we are going to be broadcasting live. We need to think of somebody to get on the show. You know what I mean? Like somebody associated with Rehoboth or part of Rehoboth. Like maybe the chief of police or something like that, in other words, you know, and just say, what's going on down here, you know, or so on and so forth. Maybe we should even consider, I don't know, we're going to have to think of something, okay?
We should
something
like
neat, something neat and interesting to do right there in front of the library, like get a speed reader. You know, in other words, and have a speed reading contest or something like that. I'm going to answer this one. Do I got time or not? I'm going to answer this one. Here we go. Tell me when you're ready. Tell me when you're ready. Okay. You are live. You're live on TV. Good morning.
Good morning.
And how you doing?
Doing wonderful. This is Ralph.
Ralph, how's Ralph doing?
Ralph's doing good. He remembers when he used to play racquetball with you.
I do remember you. And you still live right there on Route 1?
Still live in the same place.
Wow.
Still got my motorcycle trailer that I bought from you.
Wow. How long ago was that?
Oh, it's probably 5 years, something like that.
Gosh, that's got to be worn out by now.
Yeah, it's time to buy a new one.
All right, we're here till 1 today. Wow.
What else did I got to tell him?
Go ahead.
There's one other thing I wanted to mention to you.
All right.
I wanted to mention that we were watching you on WRDE-TV.
All right, and are we crystal clear?
Crystal clear.
Good. And anything else going on in your world?
No, we were thinking about going down to the auction today to see you and maybe pick up some of those neat things they have at the vendors.
Oh, yeah. And if you're coming, I'll hold out on lunch and let you buy my lunch.
All right.
No, I'm just kidding. But I'll look for you there, Ralph. Hopefully I'll get to see you.
All right.
All right.
You have a good day.
Yep, thanks for calling us. Bye-bye. All right, everybody, we took a couple callers. That was nice. I do remember playing racquetball with him. Your dad played with us, too.
Wow.
Yeah.
I could just see you guys.
Oh, we were fierce racquetball players. We had a lot of fun. Sometimes people got hit in the front of the head, and some people they got hit in the back of the head. So I miss those days. We used to play racquetball in Milford, I think, like at 6 o'clock in the morning. What are you telling me? We're back on the radio now. All right, so we had a few phone calls. That was kind of nice. Let's take a. I'm about out of time, aren't I? I got
a couple commercials still to do.
All right, so we've had a lot of phone calls. If you want to guess how much all these items that we're going to give away add up to, if you're the person who guesses, so here's it in a nutshell. There's 77 items sitting here on the table. We're going to give them away. If you give us a call at 337-7300, 337-7300 before 845, you guess a dollar amount. If your dollar amount is closest to the dollar amount these add up to, without going over, you will win all this stuff for free. Is that right?
That's correct.
It's going to be one winner. Is that right?
Yep.
Okay. Now, so those 77 items are going to go. All right. What is the next thing I need to talk about? I feel like I'm behind on things.
Jerry's Lawn Care.
Jerry Santoro. Real good guy. Does a good job of keeping up with our grass around here. Not to mention, he does all kinds of lawn care. So if you got some stuff you want done, he may do it. He may not. I know he does lawn care, but, you know, if you got some other stuff. I know he trims trees and cuts them down and cuts them up and digs up stumps and grinds up stumps and all that. But another thing, it's the time of year people are thinking about firewood. So if you need some firewood, you give Jerry a call. He's a good guy. He'll give you an honest price, and when he delivers it, it will be delivered. And if you buy a cord, you'll get a cord. And if he tells you it's seasoned, it'll be seasoned. So it's Jerry's Lawn Care. Whether you need firewood, whether you have an irrigation system and you want to get it winterized, he can help with that too. So anyway, Jerry's Lawn Care, his phone number is 363-6025. That's 363-6025. And you say, what does he do again? This dude does pavers. He's a certified E.P. Henry paver installer. He sells firewood. He cuts down trees or cuts trees up. He deals with stumps. He does a little bit of everything. So he does lawn care. But his estimates are free. He's honest. He's a hard worker, and I found his prices to be more than fair. So if you need anything done, why don't you give Jerry a call and see if he'll do it for you? His name is Jerry, and his phone number is 363-6025, and on the web, it's jlc-llc.com. Now, we've had a lot of phone calls here today.
Yeah, we have.
And I think somebody's going to win that box of stuff. Is that right?
Yes, they are.
Okay. And it's a very heavy box. All right? So it's 77 items. What?
I see you struggling bringing it in.
It was unbelievable.
Yeah.
And as I was struggling, guess what I was thinking?
What are you thinking?
I've been on a trip, and I did a lot of riding, and I am ready to go to the chiropractor. So it got me thinking about Dr. T, Dr. Bud, Peninsula Chiropractic Center. I missed them. And they do a great job for me. I think Brooks is very happy dealing with them.
Absolutely.
I have to confirm with them whether they're happy dealing with you, but you're happy dealing with them. But, folks, what I'm talking about is a chiropractor. So if you've never been to a chiropractor, I've been going for years, and I love it, okay? It just feels good. It's instant relief. And everything starts with your what's that word, with your spine and your circulatory
central
nervous system, right, in other words. And so if you have never been to a chiropractor, give them a try. Now, they have an offer. So here's the offer, and it's a really unique offer. There's two doctors there, Dr. Trulia and Dr. Bud. And Dr. Trulia is the owner-operator of the business. So it's a locally owned, operated business. Everybody there, from the people that answer the phone to the people that help with your insurance, to the people that help you in any way, shape, or form, the massage therapist, everybody is very friendly, very professional, and very helpful. So if you happen to need chiropractic care and you're not sure if it's for you, they have an offer. If you give a call to 629-4344, 629-4344, and say, hey, I heard Jim Weller talking about you. I don't know if chiropractic care is for me or not. I'd like to meet with you. They will give you a free consultation with one of the doctors where you can sit down, discuss what you've got going on, and they will let you know whether they think chiropractic care will help you or not. So the phone number is 629-4344. If you want that free consultation, you just mentioned Jim Weller or Weller Does Delmarva. On the web, it's peninsulachirocenter.com. Been around 25, 30 years. They do a good job. You can also like them on Facebook. They have very convenient hours. They're very accommodating, and they accept most medical plans. And if you've ever been involved in an auto accident and you are getting treatment pertaining to that, in most cases, there's no money out of pocket. So, again, it's 629-4344, 629-4344, Peninsula Chiropractic Center. All right, the phone is ringing. The door is swinging. And we're going to give this box of stuff away to somebody. Now, it's 8:40. You got 5 minutes left. If you want to guess the dollar amount of all these items, 77 items, you got to guess how much it is. I'm going to scan it with a microphone so you can see it, okay? So there it is.
I think Jim has officially lost it.
Oh, my. All right. So anyway, you want to take a phone call live? Will we do with it?
Do you want to catch up first?
Hey, I'm looking for a business person that has bought. I'm looking for anybody that has bought something from Weller's and has a good, positive experience they'd like to share. You call me now and we'll get you live on the radio. 337-7300. This is your opportunity. And if you own a business, we're going to let you put a plug in for your business. Is that okay?
Works for me.
337-7300. If you want to call now and just tell us about an experience you had with Weller's, whether it was years ago when I had the tire business in Lincoln, or even if you, we got a call. This is going to be real. Are you ready? I'm going to answer the phone. All right, now you're live. Good morning. Can you turn down your volume on your TV or radio?
Sure, I'll leave the room here.
All right, and we've got you live on the radio.
Hi.
Hi, how are you today?
Good, good. I just got up, and I just heard the 77 box of things, but I didn't know if this was the right number.
It is. I got you on the air right now live, so don't guess on the air. I'm going to hang up and let you call and leave it, because I don't want everybody else to hear your guess. Is that okay?
Okay. But what I wanted to say, my experience with Weller's, is that what you're calling on?
Yes.
About?
Yep.
Okay. we won a prize for the last time that you had a lottery or a drawing or something.
Okay.
And my husband won the dial thing at the picnic-like thing.
Oh.
And then we came to the shop and picked up things, and everybody was so nice and so pleasant and so helpful, and it's really a pleasure to come shop at your place.
Well, good. Well, thank you. And are you watching on TV or listening on the radio?
Radio.
Radio. And do you listen often?
Yep. Yep. When I can.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for the kind words and the call. And I'm going to hang up and let you call and put your guess in, okay?
Okay. What is the number for the guess again?
Same number. Yep. 337-7300. You got to do it before 8.
Oh, I got a recording before.
Yeah, that's what you should get. That's what you should get. I just happened to answer the phone.
Okay, great. All right, thank you.
All right, bye. What did you say, Brandon? Okay, good. Okay. Well, anyway, folks, I'm just letting you know that, yes, when you call 337-7300, you are going to get a recording, and you simply guess one time, one guess per person, just guess the dollar amount that all this stuff adds up to, and if you got the closest guess without going over, you win the box of stuff.
Yep, we got 2 minutes left.
Would you say this is the most amount of phone calls we've ever got?
I would think so.
What do you think there, Mr. Ritter? He has no idea. These guys are just busy calculating everything. All right, we are going to for sure have a winner, okay? So can I talk about my accountant?
Yes.
All this has made me think about bookkeeping now. In other words, I'm like, oh, my gosh, I went from one thing to another. We didn't get to go outside today. I am going to the BBQ. So if you're there, look me up, okay? It's the second annual BBQ by the Sea. And it's down at the Delaware Seashore State Park, and that's right over the Indian River Inlet Bridge. $5 to get in, and a lot of things going on, but I'm going for the tags. But I might force myself to eat some food. I got to tell you guys, the phone is ringing off the hook. Anyway, let's talk about accounting. We're keeping all this stuff straight because Brandon's over there trying to get everybody's guests together. George Luff, Luff & Associates, great company to deal with. My daughter mentioned them on the trip. We deal with George and his team as far as all of our accounting work have for years. So it's called Luff & Associates. They have an office in Dover and Milford and Rehoboth. All right. Been around a long time. I've dealt with them a long time, at least 25, 30 years, maybe even longer. I've been in business 42 years. I bet you I've dealt with George for 35 years. But anyway, we used to do our own payroll here at Weller's, and it was so aggravating and intimidating because there's always a change, and if you do anything wrong, it's all on us to get it straight. And Luff & Associates started a new thing called Easy Payroll, and we said, you know what, we're going to give this a try. It has been such a blessing to us to not have to worry about all these payroll-related type things. Now, I've talked to some people that said, well, I don't deal with Luff & Associates for my accounting work. I either do it myself or have somebody else. But who I deal with doesn't offer do the payroll service. Can I deal with Luff & Associates? Yes, you can. So if you do your accounting work with somebody else, but you would like Luff & Associates to help you with your payroll, they can do that. It's called Easy Payroll. You give them a call. They'll talk to you about the different services they offer, how little you can be involved, or how much you want to be involved. If you want them to do every bit of it, they can handle every bit of it. So their phone number is 422-9699, 422-9699. It's luffcpas.com on the web, whether you need accounting at work done for you, whether you need advice. They do personal as well as business, but they also do payroll. So if you have a business with two employees, they can help you. And if you have a business with hundreds of employees, they can help you. Again, 422-9699. George Luff and his team will do a good job for you. All right, no more calling. No more calling to guess the dollar amount of the items that we're going to be giving away. So here's what somebody's going to win, and we're going to tell you before this show is over who the winner is. So you get 6 air fresheners. So somebody is going to win because we've already got a number that will win. So no more phone calls, okay? All right, they won't count. 6 air fresheners. So you got 6 of them, all right? You put one in each pocket. You can put them in your vehicle, wherever you want to put an air freshener. 3 packs of pens. So there's 10 pens in each pack. How many is that, Brooks?
I wasn't paying attention.
All right. It's 90. No, it's 30. 30 pens. 3 packs of 10 is 30 pens. Now, the next question is a Zag cleaning kit. This is like a cleaning kit, like a little cloth and a little spray bottle full of stuff for cleaning off your, you know, tablets or cell phones or, you know, your computer screens or whatever. Then 20 packs of tissues, 20 packs of tissues, a binder, a real nice zipper shut. I think it's called a pad folio or something like that. This little die-cast type tractor trailer, a tag that says if you can't run with the big dog, stay on the porch. An umbrella carrier, like you would go to the beach, you put the umbrella in it, put it over your shoulder. It's the carrier, not the umbrella, but the carrier. 6 pairs of women's socks, a leather wine bottle carrier that carries 2 bottles of wine, 2 rat traps. That's a male and female rat trap, okay? So one for the male, one for the female, okay? Or if they happen to be twins or something like that. But anyway, and then a nice little mug, a NASCAR-related mug with a T-shirt in it. So all of these things is like, it's 44 things, but 77 items. You need to guess. You need to guess. Are you about ready? Uh-oh, you got more questions? Brandon is double-checking every electronic device in the room to make sure that we get it right. And I think he's still waiting for his first phone call. But anyway, he's so popular. So anyway, no, people don't like to bother him. They just like to talk to him in person. But anyway, sales today. What's going on today? The store's open now. We open at 8 on Saturdays.
Yep. You just want to come in. You want to ask for Brooks?
Ask for Brooks and Earl will take care of you.
But we're looking.
Earl will introduce you to Brooks after he's done selling you something.
As long as it goes what? To me, I'm good. We are looking. We've got some good big goals for this month.
Last month, didn't we?
Yeah, and we're looking to keep the train going down the track. So
Trump train moving. Not the Trump train. Who even thought of that word? Trump train.
But come on in. The deals are really
trailer
great.
Train. Keep the trailer train rolling.
There you go. And we'd love to sell you something. So come on in. We're here till 1 o'clock today, and we'll get you fixed up.
All right. 337-8228. Are you ready? Come on over and have a seat. This is our official, what do they call it, comptroller? What is it, like at the lottery, they got some real high technical person there? What's that word?
I don't know.
Penny
counter? All right, so tell me, what do you think of this contest?
This was an interesting contest. I actually enjoyed it. It's kind of cool.
Okay, and have you had a phone call yet today?
I have not had a phone call yet.
All right, 542-7794. Somebody needs to call Brandon and say good morning, because the dude has not had one phone call yet today.
It's giving me a complex. And all these.
Is your phone on?
It is on.
Oh, okay.
It's attached to my hip.
All right. I think this is one of the biggest contests we've ever had.
Yes.
All right, and we do have a winner?
We do have a winner.
All right, so let's go over this and make sure we got it all right, because there's a lot of legalities to this. Is that right?
That's correct.
Okay, in other words.
A lot of rules.
It's a box of it's not really junk. It's stuff.
Miscellaneous stuff.
Miscellaneous stuff. And we just want to get rid of it. We've been trying to sell it, so we're trying a new technique now. Now we're going to give it away, okay? So anything we can't sell, we just then eventually give it away. Is that right?
Correct.
So we put it all in a box, and we're giving it away. We're only giving one away, and we had a bunch of phone calls. Folks, if you've been watching and listening to the show, you heard the phone ring, you know, just time after time again. So probably 40, 50 different calls came through here. I don't even know if it tells me how many phone calls I got, but some of them, it puts numbers next to them. See that?
Yeah, where they called multiple times.
Yeah. So anyway, good turnout. Thank you, everybody. So who is the lucky winner?
The lucky winner is Mr. Snooky Vent.
Is it really?
Yes.
Go, Snooky.
He's good.
All right. Well, you come get it, because we need to get you in the store so we can get some money out of you. There is a small handling fee, okay? So what was Snooky's guess?
Snooky guessed $60.
And what did it add up to?
$70.47.
Really?
Yep.
He was the closest without going over.
We had a lot of wild guesses. We had one person guess $350. $337.
They don't know how unwilling to give stuff away I am.
Yeah, but a lot of them were close. We had a gentleman guess $77, so he was just a little over.
He was over.
Just a little over.
We need to do this again, don't we?
We do.
We need to take a kayak and fill it full of pennies.
That would be fun.
You know it?
How many pennies did make the kayak sink?
Then you have to guess how many pennies are in it.
I'm going to be sick that day.
You were thinking, take the kayak out in the water. That's what we need to do. We need to do the show live at a lake. And what we need to do is every 5 minutes add some more pennies to the kayak. You have to guess how many pennies it takes to sink the kayak.
Yeah.
That would be...
We're going to need a bank sponsor because we're going to need...
I'm going to need an insurance agent for that.
We're going to need a lot of pennies.
Yeah, we're going to need a bank sponsor, right.
And somebody willing to go scoop out all the money out of them. Right. Lake.
All right, something like that is what I meant, okay?
Yeah. Well, if we at least do it in a pool, you know, we can recover the pennies.
Yeah. That's right. You'll be able to slice the liner open and get the $82 worth of pennies out.
The metal count in the water over
right. This was a good contest. Snooki, you got to come get it while you're here. Browse around, you know, see if we can find something to help relieve you.
Absolutely.
Of some of that excess back pain on your left hand.
We'll have a cover charge as he comes through the
cover door. Charge. There you go, Snook. So anyway, Snook Event, good guy, good local businessman. Brandon's getting his first phone
call.
Hey, thank you very much for calling him. He's going to answer it now. All right, look, Colin, come on over and help me finish the show. I need your opinion of this highly intelligent contest. Did I do all the ads, Brooks? Did I miss anything?
No, you're good. You're covered.
Did I mention we have calendars?
You did.
Okay, and we're going to give them away today?
Sure.
Colin, how you holding up?
I'm doing good.
What did you think of this idea?
I thought it was great. I like it.
Hey, you know what we haven't done?
What haven't we done?
We have not opened the grab bag I bought.
Oh, that's right. Does that come with this?
No, this is my stuff.
Okay.
That's what my grandkids would say. This is my stuff.
My stuff.
All right, what should we do with this now? We should have a contest where people guess what's in here.
Just open it.
No.
Just open it.
Let's think this through. We should have a contest next week. Next week's going to be real busy. Let's talk about next week real quick. Where are we going to be?
We're going to be right on the avenue in Rehoboth.
Okay.
Look for the big Catch It Live truck, big production truck.
Hey, maybe we can get to Delaware 105.9. I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see. Tent. We'll see about that, yeah.
And we could get a wacky
see what we have room.
Arm guy and put him on top of the
We need to get Seth, the highway dancer, there next Saturday.
We're going to be right in front
can
of the library.
Him?
No.
All right.
I'm going to leave that up to you.
We're going to be right in front of the library.
Right.
Okay.
With the Catch It Live truck.
Ooh, okay.
So that's where we'll be.
We're going to be giving tours of the truck?
No.
Okay. It'd be busy with all them wires sticking
yes.
out of it everywhere.
I'll be in my little
busy.
Room.
Yeah. All right. So anyway, we're going to be live next Saturday. We got to think of a contest or idea or something. Is that mm-hmm. correct?
That's correct.
I think we should have a speed reading contest. Okay? See mm-hmm. which one of us can read the fastest.
And comprehend.
And comprehend. All right. I don't want to open this yet.
Okay.
I want to make a contest out of it. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I want people to guess. All they'll have to do is guess one item that's in here or something. So I'm going to set that off to the side. Sorry about that. I did only buy one, other than the ones my grandkids got. And they were not giving up none of it. I had to go back in and buy my own. All right. So what else do we need to talk about? Anything?
I don't know.
Wall Service Center should be open.
Yes, they are open. I've checked.
They are open.
Yep, I've checked.
Okay.
They are there. They're open. So
Brandon's got his first phone call.
Did he? Great.
All right. He could take the rest of the day off. What'd you say it was about? Cookies?
That was Dr. T.
Oh, Dr. T. Thank you, Dr. T, for calling him.
Confirming his appointment.
No, he was upset he missed it.
I got a text, too, from somebody saying they were listening.
Okay. He got a text, too. Very good. All right. So anyway, the store's going to be open. Brandon's going to be in sales. Brooks is going to be in sales. Is Earl in today?
Yes, he is.
And Terry's here, I think.
Yep.
And Jason is here.
Yep. We got a
so
full staff
we got a
today.
full staff. So anyway, we just want to welcome you to stop by Weller's Utility Trailers. We're on Route 13 in Bridgeville. 337-8228 is the number. But why call us when you can come see us? What the heck? And we love contest ideas. We need ideas. That should be a contest in itself, having contest ideas. I know you guys hate this mess, but I have a good time with it. We did have the phone calls today, even though all we resulted in was giving stuff away. But if we do that in volume...
We'll give a lot of stuff
oh
away.
Oh, boy, we'll give a lot of stuff away. You know what we need to do next is just give a whole tractor trailer body full of stuff away.
I'll start loading one now.
Yeah, start loading one now. All right, everybody. So anyway, it's Weller's Utility Trailers. Please like our Facebook page. My goodness, we need some more likes, don't we?
Yes, we do.
We're trying to get to one gazillion, and we're not quite there yet. So
got a little ways to go.
All right, you're going to be with us next week?
Yes.
Brandon will not be with us next week.
No, he won't.
Colin will be there. You'll be there.
Yep.
We're going to be downtown Rehoboth. We're going to invite people to stop by and say hi.
Absolutely.
So maybe we'll have a little open mic some. I don't know if we're allowed to do that or not. Do you think?
Probably.
Okay.
Stop by Dunkin' Donuts and bring a tray of donuts with you.
Oh.
A box of coffee.
Speaking of donuts, this is a horrible thing. But I found a really good donut store in Myrtle Beach called the Donut Man. And even more horrible, he was open 24 hours a day. He was glad we met.
Oh,
oh my gosh. Anyway, so, yeah, bring us some donuts next week. Is that right? All right. So, anyway, thank you for watching and listening and putting up with us. We need to get Bob Backman next week. I got to get up with him, see if he wants to come hang out with us. All right. We're done. We're done. We're done. Thank you, Fran, for all you do back at the station. It was an impeccable show. Top notch, first quality. Thank you for all your help. Have a good weekend, everybody. And we're going to finish up on the TV now, so we're still with the Cozi crowd and the Facebook Live crowd. So we'd love any input you want to give us. And if you would tell your friends and neighbors and everybody about the show, we are the largest, number one, most viewed and listened to radio TV show from 7 to 9 o'clock on Saturday morning in Lower Delaware.
On
Is that
this
fair
channel.
To say? On this channel.
Right, at
so,
this time.
Oh, he's holding up number one. Number one. We're number one.
Number one, all right.
Number one.
Yeah.
Wow. So instead of being the most watched and listened to, we're now number one. All right, so anyway, but we thank our audience very much. We appreciate your friendship and your comments and your playing along with us and just tolerating us. So come see us next Sunday. Not next Sunday. Not next Sunday. Next Saturday. Come see us next Saturday. And where? Downtown Rehoboth, right?
Right.
Okay.
On the avenue, right out in front of the library.
Right on the sidewalk.
Yep, we're going to be right there at the sidewalk, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. Have a good weekend, everybody. What have I got, about 30 seconds
about
left?
About 30 seconds,
Let me think. What can I think of in 30 seconds?
Why don't
donut
you just start
man.
Counting backwards?
The Donut Man. His donuts were actually, man, they were really good, Brooks, I'm telling you. Brandon Brooks, anybody that's listening, they were really good. But anyway, I'm back in Sussex County. I'm excited. Next Saturday, please come see us. And if you're at the BBQ, look me up. Other than that, God bless you. Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.